Good evening. It is 8 o'clock Pacific here in Los Angeles, California. We're in my living room. My name is Tom Green. Tonight on the show from Jackass, Steve-O, taking your calls for a full hour. Hello, everybody. My name is Tom. I'm here in my living room right now. This is my living room. And I'm excited about the show tonight. We have Steve-O here, who's been here several times before, he's a friend of the show. He's just arriving now, I believe. Is Steve-O actually in the house right now? Is he? You know what I want to say before we bring Steve-O out here? Before we bring Steve-O out here onto the stage to talk to you and to take your calls, I want to say that Bill Snitzer, who is running the controls tonight, did a pretty damn good job of the opening of the show today. Not only did the computer did not only not crash, but Robert, did you see how it started the show tonight? It started all faded up from black. Talks to me, right camera. One, I say a little thing, boom. It's not like I don't have to say roll the opening. It's like he sensed there was time to roll the opening. Boom, just dropped it. Really smooth. Steve-O, come on in here, man. Come on in here. How you doing, buddy?
Really good, man.
Nice. Happy holidays, man.
Thank you, bro. Thank you.
Happy holidays are over.
I know, fuck that shit, dude. I hate Christmas.
How were the holidays?
It was cool, man. I went home to Florida for 3 weeks.
Yeah.
Three weeks
in Florida.
Yeah, dude, totally.
What do you do in Florida for 3 weeks?
Whatever.
You know, I'm really excited about the new year here, Steve-O.
Dude, you're not the only one.
Are you? Yeah, I hear you've got some news to report.
We're going to
report it first here on the National Webovision.
I don't know. I kind of leaked it all over the internet already, but...
Oh, really?
Yeah, I'm pretty excited,
man. So this
isn't
a scoop for me or anything?
I mean, I'm moving forward with Universal Records. I'm going to make the most ridiculous rap album the world's ever heard of.
Oh, my God. No, no way.
Yeah. I've been writing my ass off, you know?
Who are all these people? Hello. There's a lot of people here. And have you been writing a lot of lyrics, you say?
Oh, yeah, big time, dude.
Oh, really? What kind of flows, what kind of topic material, what kind of subject matter?
I've got a new song called Down With STDs. It's pretty massive.
Okay.
I got my my new website up and running. It's stevo.com.
Okay.
Hey, dude, can we fire up stevo.com?
Yeah. You can fire that up right now.
Yeah. I mean, it's gonna blow everyone's minds.
Yeah. Let's have a look at it right now.
Yeah, STEVEO.
Yeah. Can you bring that up, Robert?
Yeah. Okay, and then right on the main page, it says amazing new rap song.
Oh, you can hear some of the music right there?
Unbelievable,
dude.
Who
are you recording this with? Are you working with any producers, Jermaine Dupri?
I was in Howard Stern's studio, and I brought Sam Macaroni, the human beatbox.
Who's that?
I mean, this is like...
Is that the guy from Roots? Who's the guy from Roots that does the beatbox?
Yeah, this guy's
get him
better.
On the album.
So do we click amazing new rap song? I mean, for crying out loud, dude.
You know, we've really become quite the well-oiled machine.
Yes,
around
here it is, amazing new rap song, dude, right
look
there, bro.
Up, right?
Come on, right, dude. Right. Click admit.
Down.
There you go. Oh my God, get ready to be happy. You're not gonna believe the way that my...
Are we gonna be able to hear it right here?
We should
be able to
hear
it. Yeah, really? Dude.
Really? Oh, cool. Click that, son of a bitch, dude. What the fuck's so hard about click amazing new rap
song? I got
song?
A new keyboard. Maybe we can
make
a beat after if you want.
Yeah,
whip
dude,
something
yeah.
together for the channel.
So who all famous people have been here since?
Well, I've been on holiday too.
Really. This is
I've been on holiday myself. I'm just back.
Hey, crank it up, dude. Crank it up.
You know, listen to this. World premiere.
Yeah.
Right here.
Loud,
on
dude. This guy's blowing it. Solo. Well, we can't fucking hear shit, asshole. Dude, take him to the top like that loud.
Is that on the Howard Stern show?
Yeah, yeah, dude. This was one chance. Do or die.
You can swear and do all this.
Oh, yeah.
Say anything you want now on the
yeah.
satellite.
Okay, crank it loud, dude. This is so good. Down with STDs. Yeah, totally. It's called Down with STDs.
You wrote this, Steve?
Yeah, literally, like, in the last, like, 12 hours.
Fuck yeah, here we go.
When I was unknown, it was hard to bone. I spent a lot of time jerking off alone.
Tugging it solo.
But now my TV's so chicks love me. That's why my dick is crawling with fleas. It's oozing cheese. It's spreading disease to mad groupies.
Stupid slut bag.
I stick my dick in the filthiest trash, and no amount of cash will get rid of this rash. Condoms are something I will not stash. They take all the fun out of fucking ass.
Fucking condom.
I got distracted there. Who are all these people that just walked into my house?
I don't know, but I don't know.
Who are you?
I'm the Dig ambassador.
Oh, you're from Dig.
Correct.
What's your name?
Nicole Williams.
Nicole Williams, yes. From Dig is here.
Hello, thank
and
you
is this your posse you're with or something?
My cousin.
Oh my gosh.
All the way from Virginia.
You roll deep, huh?
I do. Oh.
Thank you. You roll deep. That means you have a big exactly. entourage when you roll in. Because from Dig, how's Kevin doing?
Kevin's great. I ride here. Okay,
thanks for coming by the show.
Thank you.
Well, these guys are a bit intimidating, though. With the beard and the tracksuit and all that stuff.
Yeah, you know, give me an ashtray.
I mean, this is my living room here, you know. You just come walking in here, like traipsing in here, like you're in a nightclub or something.
Right now.
It's just a little weird, that's all.
Oh, man, I am flying in the greatest chick tonight.
You scared the crap out of me. I thought I was getting robbed or something.
Well, the dogs came out. They were barking, so.
I thought I was getting robbed.
Thanks, bro. Yeah, no, you thought you were getting robbed. I was completely fucking robbed.
Really?
Yeah, we were trying to listen to my song, dude, but whatever.
I know, and then all this posse of people from dig.com just come marching in right in the middle of the interview.
I know, man, I know. I had actually forgotten that I was supposed to come here tonight, and just right there in the middle of a nap, and here we go. So.
What are you doing after the show?
Oh, my God, I'm flying in, like, the most amazing chunk of puss, you know, like an import from Tampa. So, she's gonna get into like 11 something, and from that point on, I mean, it's just gonna be like I'm gonna be incredibly busy trying to please her.
Yeah,
you know.
That's a nice, honest answer too. I like.
Yeah,
that.
Oh man, I'm gonna try my butt off. You know, like I'm not known to be that great in bed.
This is true.
Yeah.
This is what they say.
Yeah, real letdown between the sheets.
Oh well. You know what? You make up. It in other areas, I'm sure you're.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And I've got a few days, you know, to just keep hammering away at it.
Yeah.
You know, if I can just get like one climax out of her in 3 days, I'll consider it a victory.
Yeah, that's the goal.
Yeah.
Let's take a call. Awesome. Well, thanks for coming.
Hey, man, thanks for having me, dude. It's always a blast. Yeah, I love it.
No, I mean, you know, I was thinking we could have almost like a dignified discussion today, you and I.
Exactly, yeah. Dead sober, like.
Just a nice dignified chat. We'll talk to the people out there. We don't always have to be, you know, vomiting on the floor.
We really don't have to, you
covering
know?
Ourselves in liquids or whatever.
We could probably complain about, like, all these new troops in Iraq and stuff. And
yeah, we don't have to do that, though.
I mean, it personally pisses me off like crazy.
It does, yeah?
Yeah, I mean, I'm a pretty political guy.
You are? Yeah, do you speak up politically a lot?
Yeah, you remember I was wearing my Fuck Bush shirt, you know? It was actually Zach that gave it to me.
Zach Wolk, yeah.
Yeah, and, I've never worn a shirt that I've gotten more compliments for.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, you're going through the airport, your shirt says, Fuck Bush, and, like, everyone in the airport's like, no way, I love that shirt.
Wow, really?
Yeah.
People are pretty vocal about it right now.
It's just too bad that it's illegal to kill the president.
Do you have any commercial sponsors we can go to now? Or?
Hello,
you're on the air.
Hello?
The CIA just shut us down. And security just unplugged the.
It's not illegal to be bummed out that
the entire neighborhood.
Is it illegal to be bummed out that it's illegal to kill the president? Or?
No.
Nice.
You're a. But yeah, you are vocal about this then.
Well, yeah. I mean, for crying out loud.
You feel you use your position.
You know, I just watched that Inconvenient Truth movie by Al Gore. And like got nothing across to me other than if only Al Gore took office and did nothing, we'd be in such great shape.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But you know, why is there all this freezing snow here in Santa Monica? It's snowing for
the first
time.
Dude, I'm telling you, man, what global warming does is it just makes extremes more extreme. So all these fucking global warmers have us freezing our ass off in LA.
I mean, I don't know. It seems like it's getting a lot colder to me.
I know. If people would just stop with the SUVs and shit, we'd be at the beach.
I don't know, but I just think it's basically not warming, though, I think.
I know. It's
cooling.
I know.
That's an inconvenient truth.
These fucking assholes, global warming and making us freeze.
Price of orange juice is going up. Al Gore's not going to get an Oscar.
Yeah, I don't know if it was really Oscar material for Al Gore. But.
I think they're talking about it. Yeah. Hey, you're on the air with Steve-O. Why don't you ask a question?
Hey, Tom. Hey, Steve-O. What's going on?
Well, other than being robbed of my fucking rap song, but the good news is everybody knows my website now. It's steveo.com.
Yeah, more
content on this site.
We aren't really set up to play the song, right? So you go to Steve-O's site and you can listen to the song there.
Right. This is something people can do on their own. My new website's just full of filthy garbage, and I absolutely love it.
Oh, cool.
That's a good song. I heard you do it on Stern. Good job.
Hey,
so your question.
Yeah, are we going to get to hear you do any rhymes live tonight?
That's a distinct possibility, man.
It happened last time.
Yeah.
Since you got it, the mood has to be just right.
It does. Yeah. We get to that point, we warm up, we get a little bit of momentum going.
Yeah.
And then it's like impossible to stop.
Yeah.
When's your movie coming out? TV the movie. When are we going to get to see that?
That's in theaters now, dude. It started on the 12th. Yeah.
The nationwide?
Select theaters is a nice way of saying, I think, 43 theaters.
But probably spread across the nation.
Yeah, I'm over here in Rhode Island. We're probably not going to get to see it for a while.
I don't know, man. It's in New York, dude, if you want to make the trip. But...
Yeah, maybe I will. Hey, Jackass 2 is great. I'm a big fan of you guys. Keep up the good work.
Hey, man, thanks a lot, dude. I'm going to try.
Okay, let's take some calls for real, because, sometimes we just start rambling.
People are
nice like that, and they leave a nice...
It's like we get all focused, and then they distract us.
That was a good call. That was a worthwhile.
No, I'm with you.
Some good Webo vision. Hello, go ahead, ask your questions. We have Steve.
I was wondering what you're doing ever since the Jackass movie. What you and the guys have been doing.
I'm working on a show on the USA Network, and... Whoever knows when that's gonna fucking happen, but then I'm doing this rap album for Universal Records. I mean, I'm really excited about it. And
it sounds pretty good.
I know, dude, my skills are growing. I'm also working on a tour that I plan to go on in May and June.
Rapping?
No, it's gonna be like a ridiculous stunt tour.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Oh, kind of like the
Don't Try This at Home tour, except like arena rock.
It'll be what are you gonna do? You go like staple stuff to yourself every night and stuff like that?
Yeah, there's gonna be a lot of that.
How can you do that nightly? I mean, don't you sort of run out of body parts?
I'm very resilient to trauma, man. I think I'm gonna pull it off.
Yeah?
Yeah. And everything's got to be like on a bigger scale. So what I'm doing right now,
what do you mean you're very resilient to trauma? Is that just through years of experience?
I heal like goddamn Wolverine.
You
dude.
Heal? Do you actually heal quicker than normal people?
I do believe so. Yeah, I think my immune system. I'm always keeping it on its toes. You know.
Really.
Yeah.
So a cut would heal very quickly for you if you were to like hammer a stick onto your head or something like that.
Oh, check, I got this bitch-ass new tattoo.
Oh, you got a new tattoo. Yeah, this was exactly like the one that's on your back.
Oh, no, this one's more of a caricature.
Look, show it.
Yeah.
Yeah. When did you get that done? You got that done before the holiday, because you showed
it to me. Right, yeah. Well, was that old news? Dude, sorry, bro.
No, well, you showed it to me when I came over. Remember, I came over to your
house? That's right, dude. Yeah. That was a lot of fun, man.
Yeah. Hello, you're on the air.
Hey, Tom.
Hey, how are you? We got Steve-O here. Yeah, ask your question.
Hey, it's Funky Fresh Freddy. How's it going, Steve-O? Congratulations on the record deal, dude.
Thanks, man. Thanks.
Maybe you could have Tom come over and do a song with you on that album.
You know, I've got to have Tom on my album. Man.
I'd love that.
I can flow.
Incredible,
hey,
man.
I was just calling to let Steve know that I feel he was probably the greatest guest you've ever had on the show.
Oh, yeah.
Uncontested.
Yeah.
Greatest sketch on whatcha?
No, he thinks he likes you the best on this show. Best
oh,
guest
on
the
show. Oh, yeah.
You are, Steve-O.
What well, particular thanks, moment did you like when...
Maybe it was the four-hour debauchery.
The four-hour
you know,
episode.
Like, it's crazy how that four-hour episode, it upset some of my fans and it, you know, excited others.
Yeah.
I can see how it could have upset some people.
We're trying to be a little more sensible now. I mean, we've grown up since then.
Hey, I turned a lot of people onto this show from that particular show that Steve-O was on.
Yeah,
so.
That was way back in the early
years. I know,
yeah.
I feel like we kind of swapped fan bases too, you know? We're both like each more popular now.
All right, well, good luck, you guys. Good night.
Thank you for calling.
Yeah.
Nice guy. Yeah, I know, it's... maybe we got to paint the wall or something for the new year. Maybe make some changes around here. I was thinking we should get a flat screen TV up there that we could watch other television channels on, like, because I was trying to get Fox on this because I wanted to watch American Idol.
Yeah, you know that Bill O'Reilly guy. Never get bored of him.
Because American Idol's on right now. But
be very important in tomorrow's challenge.
Yeah, but that's just gonna detract from our charm and charisma.
Nation room.
Yeah. Just be cool if we could. Oh.
You
just steal it.
Studying marketing.
A shot of that. Yeah.
I mean, that's when you really lack confidence in what you're doing.
Huh? Yeah. Well, let's watch the black and white TV instead. Yeah. That's pretty cool, though. Look at that. That looks kind of neat. Some good WebOvision. What is that? Is that the CW? When did that network become the CW? Do you know what that is?
No idea, man.
Yeah,
that's
the WB is now called the CW.
Oh, yeah.
Which was called something else before.
This is so pointless.
Okay, hello, you're on the air with Steve-O.
Hey, Tom Green.
Yes, sir.
Hey, this is Hydrogen the Monkey.
Hey, nice to have you here.
Hey, this question is for Steve-O. I was wondering if I could be the next member of Jackass.
Ha!
You guys are great, man. I really do love you both, Tom Green and Steve-O. You guys are hilarious, man. Two of my top...
Where are you calling from?
Believe it or not, I'm calling from Charlotte, North Carolina. I know you got a bad rep about North Carolina, but I'm not like the rest.
I don't have a bad rep, man. Like, my webmaster is in North Carolina.
We love North Carolina.
And that's where all my work gets done.
North Carolina loves you back.
We love North Carolina.
That's good. Charlotte loves you, man. You're great.
Yeah, thanks. You know what, can we talk to the call screener? Because I don't know, like, I mean, I think the reason we have a call screener is he's supposed to have the callers have something to say.
Yeah.
Just to call up and say hi or whatever, you know, what the fuck's the point of even having a call screener? Will you put the guy on hold because he wanted to say hi? I mean...
I just wanted to talk to you guys.
You know what your job is? Do you know what you're supposed to do? Yeah. You've been doing it for like 6 months. You're supposed to say, what do you want to talk about? And then if they say, like, you know, nothing, then you hang up on them and wait for somebody who says something good.
So just fuck the other guys that don't want to say anything?
Go back in there. Go get off.
Man, dude.
Robert, can you go help him? He obviously doesn't know what he's supposed to do. I thought we've been doing this for a long... You're supposed to tell the callers. You're supposed to call up. You have a question, something, you know, you could do a little research. You go on Google, you do a little research.
And now, dude.
Look at some of the pranks that Steve-O's done over the years, some of the stunts that he's done. This is live, man. One shot. You're sitting there, you're at your computer, this is your one shot to talk to Steve-O. You can call up, you can talk to him, you can ask him a question. You just call up and say hi, you know?
I mean, none of this shit would happen when Exhibit was here, right?
Well, you know, no, it happened then, too. The problem is it keeps happening, and I just think it's probably it's something we're doing on our end. It's human error on our end. We have to help guide these people.
Yeah, it's an incompetent staff that you're working with.
Do you want to do a shot or something like that?
Sure, man. Yeah. You know, like maybe a screwdriver.
Can we get some screwdrivers in
there? Yeah, dude.
You got a... Coffee, yeah.
Yeah, coffee, screwdriver. Sure,
coffee,
let's do it all.
And a screwdriver would be good.
Irish coffee.
Yeah, dude. No.
No, but you know what I mean, Robert? Does he know what to do? I don't want to be negative. Does he know what to do? Like, someone just says, like, hi, what do you want to talk about? And they say, oh, I don't know. Then, like, that doesn't get you on hold kind of thing. You don't get on hold if that was your answer to the question. What do you want to talk about? Oh, I don't know. Yeah. God, and I just keep being negative again. Here I am again, rambling away. I try so hard to come back positive in the new year, to come back everything gung-ho. But yeah. There's always a little problem.
It's like they're sucking the light out of life on us, you know?
Yeah. Look at that. You got a coffee? Why didn't you get me a coffee?
And what about the goddamn Baileys? Do I look like I'm at an AA meeting? I mean,
Yeah, we're getting the screwdrivers, though. I said we should have a shot.
I was into the Baileys idea, man, but, you know, a screwdriver and a Baileys coffee, like, I could be on my
we
road
to get
away. You could
just go over into the kitchen and get a drink, and we could have a can.
I know, but I'm, I'm much too professional for that. Yeah.
Hello, you're on the air.
Fuck you, Steve-O, you stupid pussy. I'll kick your fucking ass.
Oh, he.
Ooh, he beat us to it.
That was the best call of the night.
I know.
It's like, he got you. Hello, you're on the air.
Hello, yeah, I got a question for Steve-O.
Yeah.
In Jackass 2, when you did the human fishing, I thought that was absolutely crazy, man.
It was probably the dumbest thing I've ever done in my life. Yeah, thanks.
Now, what was that exactly?
Well, I put a fish hook through my face, and then they casted me out, and they reeled me in through these sharks.
Oh, my God.
I had a mako shark.
The shark almost bit you, too.
This one mako shark was going for my foot, and then, you know, I was panicked. I accidentally kicked it right in the head.
Yeah, But the hook was in your mouth.
Yeah, they were reeling me right in.
Oh, my gosh.
That took some cojones, man.
Wow, yeah.
Yeah, cojones, if you want to call it that.
It's outrageous. Now, where was that? Where'd you do that? Bahamas?
In the Gulf of Mexico off the coast of Louisiana.
Oh, my God. And how big are these sharks?
There was a fucking bunch of them. Man. We had hammerhead, spinner sharks, mako. Like, really scary fucking sharks.
Why were they not biting you?
I mean,
are they
one was really trying to, but I heard Manny
scream.
What do you
mean it was trying to?
Well, you can see it just going for my foot, but I heard Manny scream, watch out, and then that made me kind of, you know, like.
Who came up with the idea?
This really creepy guy named Captain Al Walker. I mean, I cursed myself for not having thought of the idea on my own. Great idea.
I went scuba diving over the holidays.
Did you?
Yeah, I saw a couple of sharks down there, but I didn't have a hook through my lip.
I know, like, there were probably was
scar?
Sorry.
I don't see any scar. I thought there would be some kind of scarring there.
Well, it was a solid needle, man. Everyone's looking for how do you get a scar from a solid needle, you know?
Right.
Stuck it right in my mouth.
It wasn't a barbed hook, was it?
See, we're wasting people's time, man. Like, who didn't see that hit movie, you know?
Well, I can't wait for
you. We want to hear the behind the scenes, though, how it worked, you know? We want to hear your perspective.
I actually did that shit twice, man. Like, the first day we didn't get enough sharks, so I had to re-pierce and go out again.
Oh, my gosh.
All right, thanks for taking my call, guys. I'm going to get out of here.
Hey, for sure, man. Thanks, bro.
All right, take it easy, Steve-O.
Thank you. We have some champagne.
Finally.
Is that what you want, champagne?
Fuck yeah, dude. You know me.
Celebrate the new year.
Yeah, man, this is gonna be a great year, I feel like.
Seriously, I got this new keyboard. I got hooked up to this new mic. Just throw some shit together, man.
I know, dude, shit, yeah.
We did a live show, the Keeping It Real crew performed live in Las Vegas last weekend.
Nice, nice, nice.
Show Steve-O a little bit of our...
I don't know, we don't have that performance.
Why don't we have that? That was in there last night. Did you delete it? Should have deleted it. Not like we need to save it for anything. It was the AVN Awards.
Nice, yeah.
Pretty stupid.
Adult video news.
Yeah, pretty silly. Hello, you're on the air with Steve-O.
Hi, is this Steve-O right now?
Yeah, Steve-O, and this is Tom and Steve-O, yeah.
Hi, y'all. How are y'all doing?
Doing good. Where are you calling from?
Texas, San Angelo, Texas.
Oh, awesome.
Nothing good ever happened to me in Texas.
Great. A happy new year, everybody.
This jerk over there, man. Fucking get it right.
A question for Steve-O?
Yes, go ahead. Ask Steve-O a question.
I was just wondering. I love Jackass 2, first of all. It was so good. Are y'all going to do anything else, like a Jackass 3? I don't know how y'all could outdo Jackass 2, but...
You should do Jackass 4 before you do Jackass 3.
Yeah.
Flip everyone out.
Nobody's in a big rush to start doing Jackass 3, but we're not ruling it out as a possibility.
Y'all were great. Buddy. I don't know how that doesn't, y'all don't pass it, but it's great. We
well,
all
you just got to push the boundaries, raise the bar, take it to new levels, lay it down like it's never been laid down before.
You want to probably think of something that you want to do.
It's kind of wild, you know.
You write all those ideas. You write them down on paper first.
Yeah, it's like pretty easy to write. Like, you know, let's say like blindfolded in a bull ring. You know, writing it's easy. It's filming it's hard.
Yeah, painful.
Yeah.
You want to take a break from that?
I know. I think we all have a lot of emotional healing to do.
Really?
Oh. Yeah, going to work was just really scary. It's cool. I've been like, the last 3 days, I've just been like lounging in my house. Yeah, a little R&R.
Yeah. No, I know. It's good. Yeah. I know. I've been relaxing a lot too.
Skating again? And the legs all healed up?
Legs healed good. Yeah, look at this.
All right, so.
Jumping around.
Look at that. Y'all are doing a great job. Keep up the good work.
Look at that.
Y'all hilarious.
Actually kind of funny. Like the first time Steve-O came and did the show, I was hobbled.
I know. And we got so trashed that he kept falling down. I almost felt bad.
I had a massage yesterday. I had a lady come give me a massage.
You know, I've been really meaning to like get into that habit. The massage therapist come over and
I've never done it before. But this back thing, because I screwed my back up.
How did you do that?
I got hit by this wave and I broke two ribs. Did I tell you about that? I got hit by a wave.
When was that?
It was about a year ago.
A
little less than a year. And it's not healing good.
Yeah, that's how ribs are, man.
And all the muscles on the back, and then atrophied on the back or something like that.
Yeah, and then
like
people make you laugh and then it hurts, then you sneeze and it's to hurt you.
Yeah, so I had a lady come by and rub my back for like an hour yesterday.
Yeah, that's good, yeah.
It's kind of sitting
I think
there.
That's a good, healthy new addiction for me to take on.
Yeah.
A massage therapist.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, you should do that.
You know, you can't give up one thing without...
acupuncture is good, too. You ever done that?
Acupuncture,
Like, have you ever done that for actual therapeutic reasons?
I don't know if stapling your nuts to your leg counts as acupuncture.
No, acupuncture. Hello, you're on the air. Hello. Hello, we have 30 minutes left. Okay? The show's half over.
Okay.
You're not going to have another chance. This is it.
Nah, there'll probably be plenty more chances.
I just have a question for Steve-O.
Yeah.
Okay, I was just searching on Wikipedia, and it says he released a DVD of his... documented 5-day trip on PCP.
Yeah, they kind of wrote that up wrong. The video started after I got done smoking the PCP, but it's just like my brain fritzed out, and I was a really wacky guy for a good couple weeks.
So, let's start at the beginning here.
The video is called PCP Saved My Life.
Uh-huh. What exactly is PCP?
It's a really fucked up drug, man. Like, I can't say I never would do it again, but.
and you smoke it, and then what happens to you?
Well, there's different grades of it, you know? Like, for the first few days, I was smoking pretty low-grade PCP. But then the last couple days, we just got this crazy stuff.
Yeah.
And, yeah, it was just wild, man. I was a tough guy to hang out with for a couple weeks, but made a pretty bitchin' video out of it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, a lot of people think it's an embarrassing video for me, but...
Have you watched it back?
I did not even fucking watch it, man. I played no part in producing it.
Really?
Like, I shipped out like 125,000 copies of it without
that
watching.
That might be fun to get a copy of the PHP video. Air it on the Webovision, but also have a camera on you watching it for the first time.
We
can cut back and forth.
I actually broke down and watched it one time, but luckily I was too wasted to really remember it.
Yeah, no, but we could We could go for a hike in the morning, mm-hmm. okay? Mm-hmm. Well, then we'll go have a nice lunch, okay? We'll just have some waters and nice lunch, and we'll be sensible about it. Coffee afternoon. Okay, we'll document the whole day.
Brunch,
all that stuff, right? Maybe you'll take the dogs for a walk or something like that. And then at around, let's say 6-7 o'clock, just maybe around sunset. We'll do it at sunset.
And then
we'll air the PCP video, and then you can watch it.
Right around siesta time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hello. Well, we don't have to do that. Hello.
Hey, Tom.
Hey, how are you?
Hey, Steve-O, how you doing, man?
I'm hanging in there.
Hey, I wanted to ask Steve-O something. The first half of the show, you talked about the global warming thing. that sucks pretty bad. I was wondering, you know, what you're doing.
I grew up in Ottawa, Canada. I actually, you know, think it could go up a few degrees up
there. Yeah. I just want to know what Steve-O is doing to fight it. I mean, does cigarette smoke help fight global warming or something like that?
I haven't heard that cigarette smoking is that big of a problem, but I don't own a car, so that's a good start. I don't drive. My personal hygiene is really, really bad. You know, I'm not wasting a lot of energy heating water. You know, like.
You don't bathe.
I do.
You're doing your part by not bathing.
Right. I don't bathe and I don't drive.
I tried that too. Didn't work too well.
What's that?
You don't drive, huh?
No. Like when I go home to visit my family, I'll rent a car.
Yeah.
But
so Steve-O actually is doing
I'm
his
very,
part.
Yeah, I'm an environmentally friendly guy.
Yeah. And smoking right. cigarettes, by the way, isn't bad for the environment. That's good for the environment.
Yeah, if you think about all the years that the cigarettes are going to take off my life, those are years that I'm not damaging the environment. God
absolutely.
That's true. I wouldn't mind having you around for less.
It kills drivers.
Yeah, I mean, think of all the trash that I'm not going to be piling up, you know, when I'm dead because of the cigarettes. I mean, it's the best thing I can do for the world.
Yeah.
All right, man. Well, you know, keep fighting that global warming thing.
Fight global warming.
Yeah.
Smoke Marlboro.
Yeah.
And everybody make sure that if you haven't already, join my MySpace army. It's pretty wild, man. Like,
how do they do that? Where do they go to do that?
I've got over 209,000 friends.
Wow.
I don't have a MySpace.
How do people find it, though? Where do they go?
It's a MySpace Steve-O army.
MySpace Steve-O army.
Yeah.
Go join up.
Tell your friends to join up.
And while you're at it.
Wait, what did you say?
While you're at it, go to the front page of tomgreen.com right now. And we have there right now a feature that we've been rolling out, you could say. It's the orange button. The orange button. Use the orange button today. Tell six of your friends about WebOvision.
I'd like to hear you brag a little bit about the Yahoo business that you got going.
Yahoo. Oh well, you know, I don't really know.
I turned on my email and there you are.
I was up in New York doing. I got to go to New York City right before the holidays and judge a show. It was like American Idol, basically.
I know. Yeah.
It was basically like American Idol.
Yeah, I kind of wanted to be a judge for all this. It's like an ongoing talent show that Yahoo's doing.
Yeah. I hope they do it again. We actually have some videos here that some people have sent in.
That made me filthy fucking rich, right?
The Yahoo thing?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Rolling in.
Unbelievable.
Yeah.
Unbelievable. Look at this guy from Australia, Don Sibley. He always sends us nice stuff. Look at this. He sends videos. He uploads the videos that you can get your video upload here onto the site here somehow.
Oh, hi, and welcome to my podcast. We've got another pretty average kind of show for you today. Of course, we've got Pat with a musical talent later on, and Lansdowne with another musical fact. But I'll tell you what, hey Lansdowne, I've got a joke for you.
Okay.
Well, you know those cooking shows when they bring out a dish they prepared earlier? I kind of like that, so.
Man, 4 minutes long, we can't watch it for 4 minutes.
Nothing like a video like that to make you really feel a sense of job security, huh?
Well, that's one of our stars here, Don Sibley. He is one of our stars. Look about Einar from Estonia. We have a clip of his. This guy's a... What's the Steve-O Christmas card? Is that when we went over to Steve-O's place?
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, you know, I got a lot of good feedback about it from that.
Oh, yeah, we can watch some of that now, too. Let's play this. This guy's from... His name is Einar. He's from Estonia. Robert, did you pull this video clip down off the deputy blogs?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah? You pulled them down? So you judged this to be one of the better videos that's out there floating around cyberspace right now. That's your judgment call. You gonna play it, or how long do I have to stretch here, Bill? Bill's on the computer tonight for the first time. All right, I'll move on to something else. Hello, you're on the air with Steve-O.
Yeah, how's it going?
Good, really good.
Steve, I was wondering, what's the most craziest thing that you've ever done besides the butt chug?
The most craziest thing.
And here's this guy thinking, I've got the most original question. Yeah. It's going to be great. Yeah. Can we hang up on that asshole? Yeah.
The most craziest thing.
Just Google me.
Well, I was wondering about your new album, when it was going to come out. I was also wondering if, Steve-O, have you ever done a barrel roll in your life?
What?
A barrel roll. It's a
barrel roll.
It's a video game terminology. It's we have a lot of web people, web nerds type
you
people
know,
watching,
like
video games.
That's people why like, all of our like jobs me. Are going to fucking China and India is because we're all fucking Americans like sitting around playing video games. If I had kids, I'd rather they smoke goddamn pot than play video games.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah. I mean, at least like smoking pot and watching TV can be thought provoking. Yeah. So, you know, like.
There goes that Activision sponsorship we were working on.
Even, yeah, I've got a few video games, you know, coming down the track, too. It's not too smart.
Hello, you're on the air with Steve-O.
Tommy G.
Hello.
Hey, I just want to say, like, a couple of my favorite guests have ever been on your show will probably be Steve-O and Henry Rollins.
Oh, cool, yeah.
Henry Rollins.
And one of the classic Steve-O bits from Jackass 1 was where we received the tattoo from Henry Rollins.
Oh, yeah, right.
Yeah, that was pretty wild stuff.
Now, did he actually give you that tattoo?
No, he was driving the Hummer.
Oh, he's driving,
yeah.
Oh, wait, you were in the, right. Not the big one in your back, though. You got that in the first movie, too, though, right?
Well, yeah. I was wondering, what does that look like now? It's been a couple of years, right?
It looks just the same. Smiley face.
That's the one Henry Rollins gave you.
Well, yeah, he helped.
Yeah, while you were in the back of the Jeep.
I also heard once, I think it was on Henry Rollins' show, he had Johnny Knoxville on. They said there was some sort of connection with Henry Rollins and Steve-O with some girl in their past. They both were dated. What happened with that? Because they didn't really get into it on the show.
I think, I can't be sure that this is exactly correct, but I'm pretty sure that Henry Rollins flew out this young, promiscuous, beautiful woman, and she came out on his airfare and came to my house.
Okay. Yeah.
And, you know, I had a few bros run a train through her, you know?
Okay.
At one point, she said, man, I wish I had two mouths.
Wow.
She also told me and Pontius to stop looking at each other. She's creeping her out, you know?
Yeah.
But this was, you know, many, many, many years ago, and Pontius is married and much better now.
Yeah.
Thank
you for your call.
It was amazing. Like we actually like simultaneously ejaculated. Handled the tummy and I handled the tits, you know?
I don't know if I
but it was like
draw the line there.
The timing was incredible.
I don't need to know about the tag teaming. Hello.
I have a question for Steve-O.
Yes.
What happened with all the Don Vito footage from Jackass number 2?
All of the Don Vito footage? You make it sound like it was a real bunch.
Hello, you're on the air.
Hey guys, how you doing?
Good, we're doing real good.
Good. Steve-O, I had a question for you. What is the nastiest, sickest stunt you've ever seen that you haven't done?
I mean, there's a lot of wild shit going on out there. I like to consider it all apples and oranges. Really tough to.
Right. The beheadings are really.
Well, those aren't really
taken off,
are they? Headings. Well, my nastiest stunt that I ever saw was like that Dirty Sanchez group. They did the ass funnel there, where they poured beer into the guy's asshole and then drained it out, and one of the guys drank it.
Wow, I wonder where they got that idea.
I don't. Probably from you guys. I don't know.
Yeah.
I saw that you
guys. We've already wasted enough time on who fucking I've already forgot.
He had crack like floating in the beer, and the guy like drank it and like. His cameraman had to go throw up.
Yeah, dude, we hang up on this guy. Fucking jerk.
kind of world are we living in here, huh?
Yeah.
What kind of world are we living in?
Common decency.
We're sitting here. We're just trying to have an intelligent conversation here.
So why do women...
This is live here, right? We can't control... I want to apologize on behalf of myself and behalf of my guests to all the people at home that just heard that filth coming out of this man's talking about funnels and asses and things like this. Just disgusting.
Hey, why do women wear makeup and perfume?
I don't know.
Because they're ugly and they stink. I thought it was funny.
I'm just trying not to laugh too hard. I don't want to anger our three female viewers. Hello, you're on the air.
Oh, Tom Green, honor, dude.
Hey, how are you?
Good old Uncle Steve-O.
Yeah.
Oh, man. It's been a really long time listening to you guys for a long time. See you guys on Jackass and the Tom Green Show. Just really love you guys.
Stop gushing. Now let's get to the meat of it.
Oh, the meat of it. All right. Well, Steve-O, I was just watching your Career Ender DVD, the Career Ender.
Yeah.
I was wondering, like, wow, dude, that's a heavy load to watch.
That is, another video in the archives of what I'd call embarrassing.
Which one was this?
It was the call now and purchase with your credit card, and we'll include this bonus video so filthy that industry professionals have sworn its release will end Steve-O's career. I set out to, it was incredible. I mean, I was just like, my hair watched me take three pills of ecstasy at once and make out with a bunch of dudes, like.
Well, dude, I really appreciate you taking the phone call. Thanks.
Hey, for sure, man, like,
you know what we gotta do is, maybe we could do a thing where you get, like, a bunch of clips from these videos, and you come in here, and we could just talk about them and play a clip, talk about them, some of these moments, like a retrospective.
We could wear
tuxedos.
A greatest hits.
We could wear tuxedos.
Yeah, montage of like.
Yeah, we'll put it all together. You know, we're sitting here, we throw to a clip, talk about it.
I mean, I think we've got enough great work under our belt that could be a long highlight.
Yeah, just we put it all in the computer and we throw it all down. It'd be fun to have, you know.
Yeah, you know, I really like it when people like illegally download. I think that's a sign of a true artist, when you want people to download your shit illegally,
Absolutely.
I mean, if you can get it for free, man, just kind of anything, just make sure you experience our art.
Yeah. We're pumping this crap out for free, but...
yeah, I've been pumping crap out for free like crazy.
Hello there.
Hey, Tom.
Hey, how are you?
Pretty good. This is Colin Ford from Brooklyn, Ontario. My buddy Gil called last night.
Is this guy still in there? Did he talk to the call screener yet? Can you go talk to him again?
Yeah. Killer?
You know? Go talk to the call screener again.
Yeah, now you might want to...
It's like, you know...
Make very serious threats.
I appreciate his enthusiasm, but, I mean, come on.
Jeez.
You know, I may as well not have a call screener. Hello, you're on the air.
Hi, Steve-O. This is Dirty Six from your message board.
Yeah! You know how much I love my damn message board.
Dirty Six? Dirty 36?
Not with a T, with a D.
Okay,
Yeah.
I just wanted to know, what do we do if we want you to come to our city on the tour?
That's kind of out of my control. Do you live in a big city?
I'm in Guelph, Ontario.
It all boils down to whether or not you live in a city that Steve-O wants to go to.
Well, we have a university, the University of Guelph, and I'm sure a lot of people would love to see it.
World renowned.
I know, like the most successful tour I ever did was of Canada, I think. But I heard this was gonna be a 30-day US tour, so I don't know.
Okay.
But maybe you pop up to Guelph for a little
surprise. You never know.
University of Guelph show.
Yeah.
I mean, this sounds like a girl who could make, a nookie run out of it.
Is there a possible nookie run in this here for Steve-O?
See, that's what I'm talking about. I'm really, like, my New Year's resolution was to really try and have a lot more sex this year. Make more money, become more famous, just be a goddamn fucking player,
Yeah. No, for sure. That sounds like a good, we'll put you on hold, we'll collect the digits. Go get her number for Steve-O so I can go up there. Hello, how are you? You're on the air.
Hey, Tom. This is Brendan from Bellingham, Washington.
Okay, good. Yeah.
I was just wondering, I had a question for Steve-O.
Yes.
I want to know, how long did them do that huge tattoo on his back?
All told, I think it was 16 and a half hours.
Man.
Yeah.
That's painful.
It sucks, man.
I do not have one tattoo.
After 6 hours of having your back tattooed, like, life gets really, really hard.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is it bleeding for months?
No, not bleeding for months.
Your shirt stick to you? Like, I mean,
yeah, there's a little bit of that, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Pus just dribbling down your back? Yes. It's like it fell off a motorcycle and got up and there was an image of your face on your back.
I know, but like the motorcycle fall, it's like one scrape, this is like...
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
Tom, I love your show, man.
Thank you very much. Thanks for calling.
Yeah, have a good night.
Nice to have you here.
The whole question parts just goes right over people's heads.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, one last chance for the callers. We only have 10 minutes left.
Is it really like, man?
Yeah, it just flies by.
Dude.
You're on the air.
Cool. Hey, guys. Steve-O, I was wondering, is there a stunt that ever, okay, like, almost killed you, or like the scariest stunt ever that you did?
There's been some close calls. Like, I don't know, like...
Was there ever a time when you sort of the stunt ended and you kind of replayed it in your mind over and over and thought, whoa, that could have been it?
Yeah, I call them I'm not okay moments.
Yeah.
You know, like, you just kind of land, you know, like, I'm not okay.
Yeah.
But,
kind of went a little further than even you thought possible.
Yeah. Like, those are scary moments, man. I try not to talk about them.
Really? You feel it's bad karma?
Yeah, it's just really like, you know, there's a lot of emotional scar tissue there.
Right on.
Thanks.
That's my way of saying, like, I don't want to answer the same fucking questions all over. Just, you know, like.
Man, it's nice sometimes, though, just to listen to the sound of Webovision. Like,
yeah.
Let's hang up on this guy. Listen to the sound of Webovision for a second. Like, on a television show, you can't just, I want it to have a real sensible, nice, calm show tonight.
And I did, you know, like, yeah. I think this is the most sensible and calm I've been.
Yeah, like, think about this for a second. Here we are, okay, we're on the National Webovision. We're live. You're on TomGreen.com, the channel, and Mania TV. And we're here, it's 8:49 p.m. Pacific. And just listen to the sound of Webovision. Listen to this for a second. Listen.
Let's get some glug in the back, glug, 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 you know?
Yeah.
Look that.
Studio sounds nice, yeah. Quiet at night. You know? Hey, you're on the air.
Yes, I have a two-part question. Steve-O, the first part, your upcoming USA television project, was that the one that was rumored with Banana Tony? And the second question I have is, did you know that you talk just like a baby pterodactyl?
This guy just thinks he's cooler than shit.
It's funny. Funny. Okay, what else can we have to say? Is there anything else we have to say? Can we show some of the Steve-O visit to Steve-O's house?
Yeah.
We can show some of that on the computer.
Sweet. Yeah.
Is there anything else we have to say before the end of the show tonight, other than just how happy we are to be on the air, how excited we are to be here, and how thankful we are to have all of you as viewers? Thanks for watching.
And if you
use the yellow button, the orange button is this neat thing on there where you push
and
then it opens up and you can send emails to 6 friends at once telling them to come to the channel.
Oh, cool.
I actually think people also would be fun if people could pick up their telephone right now and call 3 friends and tell them to come to the channel right now and call Steve-O. Yeah. It's like a pyramid scheme kind of thing we're trying to...
Yeah, it's almost like chain letters?
Yeah, trying to boost the ratings.
Yeah, rig the numbers.
You know? Call a couple of friends, tell them to call us up right now and talk to Steve-O.
Yeah,
we're in 10 minutes.
If for any reason anybody was disappointed with this webcast, then they can just switch over to Steve-O.com.
Yes, absolutely.
And just content for days. I mean, you guys would be howling. Howling. Crying, fucking, just tears.
Oh, yeah, no, for sure.
Tears of joy, you know.
I'm going to go, can we go there right now and look at it right now?
Yeah, yeah, bring up Steve-O.com, man. I really like need to be pushing this website.
Yeah,
like,
push it. Go check it out. Now, is this a new website?
It is, man. It is. Like, I have this fucking lawsuit's been going on forever, and I just start completely from scratch.
Right.
Can I go to gallery? Okay. Hold on one second. Okay, gallery,
hold
now
on
go
on
down
one second.
Okay, videos. Go to videos. Yep, boom. Okay, now, okay, what we want. Go down, 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 down. Okay, the one that says Ryan Simonetti right there, click that. It said rent two apartments in one building. Look what I've done with my downstairs pad. Yeah, oh man, you're not.
Is this the one that I came to with the?
No, you were. That was my upstairs pad.
Oh, okay.
Okay, and crank it up, dude. Like, this is fucking fantastic, dude.
It's Bill's first night on the computer over there. He's not
Jesus
very good with
fucking Christ. All right, here we go. Yeah, and then make it real loud.
All right, fuckers, Christmas is over. Let's warm up.
Now that's a one-bedroom apartment. No, two-bedroom apartment. And then that's my company. But way to cut it off, shit dick. Yeah. Bye bye.
Bill Snitzer, shit dick Productions. Wow, that's so. Wait, those ramps are still there?
Yeah, if you want to come over and skate, man.
Break my leg again.
Yeah, you know, I mean, you don't have to, but
break the other one.
Yeah.
I have a matching pair. Hey, are you you're on the air here?
All right, hey Tom, you're doing a great job on Webo Vision. I know it sucks getting shitty callers all the time, but...
Yeah, I know, like this one sucks. This call sucks.
I'm sure there's been a lot of great calls. It's just our screener is fucking taking a nap.
Well, no, this call sucks already.
Stephen Dorff death threat. I was wondering what happened to
Stephen
that.
Dorff death threat.
Oh, what's this? Is this something that happened?
It's funny, man. Like, I was going out with this girl, Mae Anderson, and her ex-boyfriend, Stephen Dorff, was upset that we'd gone to some bar, and so he called this nice lady and left this really nasty message calling her like, you dumb fat bitch, like, I'm gonna have y'all killed. I mean, I really felt as though my life had been threatened. So what I did was I put it all over the internet, and really the footage of this answering machine with the subtitles,
right?
And I can't imagine Stephen Dorff was very happy about it, but like, I just did that so maybe he'll learn not to be so fucking nasty.
Right.
Yeah, so he can suck a dick. The guy's about 3 feet tall too.
It's
they just call him Stephen Dorff, you know, but I'm sure that's not really a new joke either.
I can see this really got you upset.
I was just thinking, like, you know, by leaking this. And
no,
then,
are you saying that now there's no way maybe
let's,
we can,
let's go to the video gallery.
Is there any way we can patch this up between you two? I mean, Hollywood's a small town. You don't want to have this kind of negative energy.
Yeah, but you know what it's like being in the rap game, dude. You got to have beef.
Yeah.
Yeah. Stephen Dorff can suck my dick. You know? You know?
You could do a song about that, maybe.
Yeah, exactly. You know, like I've got a lot of beef. You know, like
you kind of run in the Hollywood circles. I mean, you've dated a few high profile celebrities.
I jerked off in one famous girl's bed. Yeah.
Yeah, we've heard this story before.
Yeah, I never get bored of telling it. Yeah.
What is it again? What is the story?
Nicole and Richie and I were friends. At one point, like, I was in her bed and I jerked off on her. I mean, that's like a lot better than like being like, you know, waking her up and ruining her
so
sleep.
So she was sleeping at the time, you're saying? She know this?
She was awake for the last two of the three times I jerked off on her. Okay,
this is, I mean,
you
welcome
know?
To the channel. What the hell's, what the hell, you know, I mean, but you can't talk about that you must be able to talk about that on the Howard Stern show, though.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
Have you talked about that? Have you told that story on the Howard Stern show?
Of course, yeah.
And now, what does Nicole Richie think
when
you run into her and you've told the story on all these places? Do you not feel like this?
I actually,
do you feel bad about that?
I don't, because I think that, I mean, number one, premature ejaculation is absolutely the highest form of flattery.
Yes.
And I mean, it was a fucking, you know, right. You gotta figure that she's pretty proud of that.
Sure. You're being complimentary.
Right, yeah. And, the one conversation I've had with her since then, she complimented me on my great new movie.
Oh, okay. So she knows that you've been out talking about
that. Oh, yeah. You can't pick up a magazine without reading about me spooging all over her. Even though, I was more polite than that. I spooged on my tummy.
Yes.
Then I gave myself the courteous boxer wipe. Mm-hmm. You know, you hike them all up, and then you know.
You know that one. You know how it is, huh, gang?
See, now we're warming up.
Yeah.
Fuck.
No, I mean, I think we've been, on fire all night. We're just doing that at a different volume tonight.
I know. Yeah.
I think our words are cutting through the darkness with a subtlety tonight.
Yeah, if it wasn't for all the incompetent, production staff and all the bad telephone calls, all you got is just us getting better at our jobs.
Yeah. No, we are getting good too. We're getting much better.
Yeah. Let's fucking
to us.
Down the hatch.
To us.
That's what champagne is for.
Oh man, yeah. So what, you really are, you have some girl coming into town right now for real?
Yeah, dude, I'm flying her in, bro. It's called importing a chunk of puss. Because I gotta say, dude, it's like, when I'm on tour, it's just great, because you can have promiscuous sex and then wake up in the morning and leave that town.
Uh-huh.
But I'm more based in LA now, so it just seems like every chick I fuck, won't stop calling, showing up at my fucking pad, So, since I'm not on tour, I'm bringing chicks from other parts, so then they can disappear.
Yeah. Yeah, you just bring them in for the weekend and then send them on
the the import business.
Send them packing.
Even not really, I'm kind of digging this one import.
You don't think you want to settle down, maybe? You don't ever spend a nice weekend with one of these.
It was kind of controversial,
of puss,
I think.
You don't ever and then sort of not want to send her home, not want to send her back.
When I was telling Howard Stern how I consider myself more of a lovemaker, than a fucker.
Yeah.
And I was telling him how I believe in promoting safe sex.
Yeah.
And, the only way to do that is to practice it. Mm-hmm. And, the safest sex I've ever had.
And it's best practiced while on PCP.
Right, yeah.
Kids.
The safest sex I've ever had has been with prostitutes,
Right, yeah.
So, and the thing is, I cannot fuck a hooker without, spooning and snuggling until,
No, wait a minute. You're doing stand-up comedy now. You told me you're doing stand-up comedy.
There's been some stand-up. Yeah, I have, a bunch of that on my stevo.com website, too.
At the Laugh Factory?
Yeah.
When are you going up next?
Who knows, man? Maybe, I don't know if I'm ready for tomorrow, but.
Oh, that'd be cool if you went up tomorrow. We could come down with a Webovision camera.
Yeah, I'm thinking.
What kind of watch is that?
That's going to be the presidential Rolex.
With the little diamonds on it, huh? Can we get a close-up shot of that?
Yeah.
Let's get a close-up shot of the Rolex. I have a good friend. We got it here. Don't worry about that. A good friend. His name is Bert Dubrow, and he's a. Loves. Get a shot of that watch. He'd like to see this watch. Can you hold it? Hold it steady there for Bert Dubrow. He's. I'm gonna ask, get a screen. Look at that watch. That's a nice watch.
Yeah.
How much does that watch cost, you figure?
It's like $20,000 before the diamonds.
$20,000 before the diamonds.
Yeah, and I went with the aftermarket.
Yeah.
That means I'm a.
Right,
cheapo,
you pimp your ride diamonds.
Yeah, it's like probably a $25,000 watch.
$25,000 for that watch.
But, again, I don't own a car, I don't own a house.
Yeah.
I really, the only thing I spend money on is booze and drugs, and you know, and I'm not really doing as much drugs lately, so.
Well, that's good.
Yeah, so I'm like, I'm really, I wish ketamine was easier to find because I fucking love that
what,
shit.
What are you talking about?
Ketamine.
Ketamine.
You know, like the horse tranquilizer business.
The horse tranquilizer, yeah.
I mean, I'm telling you, you do that shit, it's like you're fucking, it warps you, dude. Like, you know, you can be like in a room and like literally the room itself will just start free falling.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, I mean, so,
I mean, you look at your fucking feet, they're like fucking 30 well, yards well, away.
Why do you do that? Why
I mean,
do you,
like,
why do you want your feet to be 30 yards away?
I don't know, man. Like,
that seems like a long way away from
I know,
your feet
I mean, I'm telling you, like, it's just like, nothing is in the right. It's just fucking awesome, man. I mean, I love it. You know, like, I've been trying to get more into taking ecstasy.
Yeah.
You know, like, more like.
I've never done ecstasy in my life.
Yeah, you see, that can, you know, it's kind of a crapshoot. Sometimes it's good, sometimes it's bad. But the slight chance that it's going to be good is totally, like, worth going. You know, like. Oh. What else is fun? GHB is fun.
Where do you get all this stuff, anyways? Is it
well,
readily
I mean,
available on the streets? Or?
So where was I?
Alleyways? How do you find
I was,
some?
I was.
Where do you get a good? Where do you? Not. I mean, not exactly. We don't want to give people any ideas, but where do you get some GHB these days? I mean, if I wanted
I
to acquire
Miami,
some,
I was in Miami. Yeah, Miami on South Beach, and
see, I was looking for some GHB.
Yeah, like you want to go into the gay bar and, you
really?
Know, like really establish a rapport.
What is it? Is it a little tablet or something?
GHB is a liquid.
A liquid?
Yeah, so you want to go into a gay bar and you just want to say, like, whose dick do I got to suck to get some date rape drugs around here? You know? You know, like that ought to do it.
Right, right. I don't know if I don't know if it's worth, I don't know if it's worth the effort. Hello, you're on the air.
Hey, is this Tom Green?
Yes, yes, sir.
I'm no time, Steve-O.
Yeah, Steve-O's right here.
Hey, I was wondering, should weed be legalized, and what's your favorite bud?
Should we be realized to the motion of your butt?
We're having a hard time hearing you.
What's see, that? This guy's not, he's been treating himself to date rate drugs. You know, like, that makes it tough to.
Hey, how are you?
Hey, good. How's it going? Am I on?
Yeah, you're on. Go.
Hey, I wanted to tell you, you guys are the future of entertainment. I just got to say.
You know, future uh-oh. Of entertainment, the God. Past of entertainment, yeah. You know.
Figures we'd be there during the apocalypse.
You know, so. It's so awesome, man. Like, you know, like, let's say, like, my TV projects fall through, you know, like, you're like, you don't, like, have anything really going on TV, like, who cares? Like, nobody wants to fucking hire us on TV. We're just gonna fucking do it anyway. Fucking put it out on the internet for
yeah.
free.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah. Make yeah. people happy.
Yeah, fucking goddamn right. You know, like, never really was motivated by
money. Well, I mean, you
money.
Know, if you want to do TV, you kind of basically have to do Dancing with the Stars.
Yeah, and then, like you
that.
Know, the fucking editorial
would you
sword
ever do that? One of those kind of shows? A Dancing with the Stars kind of shows? Would you do that?
I'd probably rather be on fucking Hollywood Squares, dude.
Yeah.
And that's my way of saying no.
Yeah.
my sister said she'd disown me if I did any bullshit like
yeah.
that.
Because that stuff's sort of, well, yeah, that's a good way of describing it. Hello, you're on the air.
Hey, Steve-O, I just want to know if there's anybody that you haven't worked with yet that you want to. I'll hang up.
There's a lot of
no. Don't hang up,
no,
Jenna.
No. She sounds very fuckable.
Yeah. Well. Where are you from?
I'm not even gonna tell you where I'm from, Tom. You know, I'm gonna see Neil Hamburger tomorrow. That's where I'm from.
I've got a question for Tom. I got a question for you, Tom.
Oh, Victoria, British Columbia.
I got a question for you.
Yes, sir.
Remember that girl I was dating for a minute there, Alicia Gutierrez?
Yes, yes, yes.
Now she's all like, oh yeah, I know, Tom. Like, you know her pretty well, right? Well, like, come on. Like, I mean, I was stirring your porridge.
We gotta let you
right?
gotta let you go here, Annette. We have something to talk
was,
about.
Was I chasing you into that hole?
Like, no. But that was bizarre, though, wasn't it? It's now, where is she?
You know, and it seems like...
Are you going out with her anymore?
No.
Is she still in town?
No, I couldn't tell you, but... it just
could seems... I go out with her again if you're not going out with her anymore? I just went out for lunch with her one day. That's it. That's all. Nothing debaucherous.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You just ate her out for lunch one day?
You know? I'm not going to say, just to keep the suspense going. No.
Nice, I mean, girl. I don't mind sharing chicks, dude.
No. Well, you know what? I have had situations like that before, but that's not one where we've actually really shared.
Like, one of the most
special things. I wish we were sharing her.
I know that.
She's quite the woman.
I know, like...
Yeah, she's all woman.
So cool, like you know, back in, like, the early days, like, with the Jackass bros, it's like, if one guy went to go get checked out for STDs, it's like, you know, provided he came up clean, it's like the rest of us, like whew, sweet, we're clean, you know. It's like only one of us had to get tested for the whole crew.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's disgusting.
Yeah.
Hello.
I mean, if you believe in microbiology.
Yeah.
You know, which is obviously a bunch of fucking propaganda to sell goddamn otherwise useless latex.
It's overhyped. You're on the air.
Hi, I was just wondering, now this is a story all about how my life got flipped turned upside down, and I'd like to take a minute and just sit right there. I'll tell you how it
that is what I call a white rapper.
Yeah.
That was funny, dude. You're supposed to laugh.
That was. Well, yeah. He's not actually rapping, though, is he?
Yeah, that was Will Smith.
That
right?
was Will Smith. Yeah.
Okay.
I thought you actually thought he was rapping. I was like,
I mean, he's definitely not on our level.
No, that's true. It's true. That was a hype song, though. That
I had this fucking.
I beg to differ. I thought.
I was thinking
Will
it's like
Will Smith and DJ Jazzy Jeff. And,
to break into the rap game for me, I feel like I want to like tell my story. You know, like.
Yeah.
You know, like, I made my own money because I am funny. I lube up bitches with cans of honey. I rap for fun and I party for work. Watch me get drunk and act like a jerk. My mouth, I get so high, my mouth becomes dry. If I run out of weed, then motherfuckers die. I'm not a nice guy. I'll fucking kill you and I won't say why. That's a mean guy, right?
Yeah, like, that's, yeah.
Yeah, and then I get really fucking violent.
Yeah.
I'll tear off your arms and I'll shove them up your ass and then I'll kick you in the nuts and I'll smoke some fucking grass. You know, I got mad class. I think of rhymes real fast. Fucking like, you know, and then you just gotta like, you know, talk about just kicking people in the face and their fucking shit's gonna swell because I do my job well and like, you know, like I may go to hell but I'll not cease to sell. You know, like. Shit like that, you know, like really. And I feel like that's the song I want to record with you because we're kind of in the same boat right there.
Yeah.
You know?
It's like, fuck it.
I want to like not get like lumped. I don't want to get lumped into like the K-fed like pathetic rap category, you know?
Yeah.
Like I want to be the second funniest rapper in the rap game.
Who's
you know?
The funniest? Eminem?
K-Fed, come on. You know, you're not gonna get funnier than K-Fed, damn it. Like,
oh, K-Fed.
The thing is, like, he's not trying to be funny.
Right. I didn't actually hear his rap album.
I honestly haven't. I like the guy. I know. Like,
do you know him personally?
I've actually got completely trashed with him. Like, I think within like 48 hours of the birth of his fourth baby.
Wow.
Yeah, we were really like celebrating pretty hard. Nowhere near the baby.
Can we call him right now? Do you have his number?
I do.
Want to just call him?
Yeah, let's call him, dude.
We'll just call him live
let's
on the phone. Let's call K-Fed live right now. Is he in L.A.?
I don't know, man. I don't know. I think he's. Oh yeah, I gotta power up the phone, dude. Know any funny jokes?
This is close. Let me just get the phone ready. We're here. Oh wow, look at that.
Oh yeah.
You know, the show's actually, we've gone 10 minutes long right now.
You know, but the thing is, dude, like, we started off so fucking slow and, like, with all these hiccups.
No, there was no hiccups.
I'm down to do another half hour, I think.
Okay, good. Well, let's do as long as you want.
We
need another drink then, though.
Yeah, that's goddamn right, dude. Is there another bottle of champagne?
Is there anything else to drink here?
Yes. I'm kind of into that champagne,
screwdriver
dude.
Screwdriver would be good.
All right, screwdriver. Yeah, good call.
Let's call K-Fed.
Okay. All right, I don't want to like have everyone know his number.
Yeah. Fed.
Okay, now what we gotta do is we gotta tell them that we wanna record a rap song with them.
Yeah, absolutely.
You wanna do a little freestyling?
Yeah, absolutely, yeah.
Alright, okay.
4, 2, 8.
Oh, wait.
7. Recognize mailbox. 82, 2.
Does that mean the guy can't keep a cell phone on these days?
I don't know.
I
said it wasn't a recognized
number. Dude, because I remember, like, he gave me the number and I called him and then my number showed up and his, I don't know. Long story short.
K-Fed. Is that his answering machine? What happened? What was it?
I don't know, but long story short, I really liked the guy.
Yeah.
You know?
I think we're on his answering machine.
Last time I saw him, I said, hey, dude.
Kevin, it's Steve-O and Tom.
We want to rap with you, bro.
You want to throw down, No, we're not on K-Fed's answering machine. How embarrassing.
You know what's embarrassing?
I'm embarrassed at how gleeful I was about talking to his answering machine, and I wasn't even on his answering machine.
Fucking bullshit, dude.
Okay, who else do you got in there? Who else can we call?
Okay.
50 Cent?
Herradura,
by the way, provided this tequila to us for free. Herradura tequila.
How about if we call Tommy Lee?
And, yeah, let's call Tommy Lee. That would be
We'll leave him the funniest fucking message.
Yeah.
Okay,
Super Dave! My God, we gotta call him.
He's, yeah, really great.
Going on. I just don't want anyone to hear. I don't want.
We gotta really leave Tommy a funny voicemail.
What, you wanna do a shot?
Yeah, fuck yeah, what is it?
Tequila.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Can I just stick with the screwdriver, dude? I don't
wanna. Oh, I thought we wanted a screwdriver.
No vodka.
God damn it, dude. Is there another bottle of champagne?
God damn it. Dude, I think there's some vodka out back.
Yeah.
Wait, let's fire up Tommy Lee, dude.
Yeah, let's call Tommy. We can do a shot.
I love great.
We should be able to do a shot of tequila if we're calling Tommy Lee, though. I mean, if you're calling Tommy Lee, you got to be able to do a shot of tequila. You know what? I hate tequila.
Me too.
Oh, man, I hate it. It just it screws me up every time.
Okay, here we go.
Yep. Tommy Lee. We're calling Tommy
Lee. He's not big into answering his phone, so it's always a voice. What are we going to say on his voicemail?
See, he's got to get over here to the channel right now.
Okay, T-Bone, you know? It's like he's got us feeling all alone, you know?
Why is it not going through? Hello?
Sorry, the Nextel number you were trying to reach is not in service at this
time. Dude, your phone's fucked up.
No. Everybody who gave their number to you has changed their number.
Oh, dude, you know what? You know how that makes me feel?
Well, I'm joking.
Like I'm doing my job very well.
Let's call someone else. What do we got in there?
All right,
let's call Super Dave. You have Super Dave in there.
Do you know what Super Dave does?
Yeah. Super Dave Osborne?
No.
Oh, a different Super Dave.
Yeah.
Not Super Dave Osborne, who probably was the 1980s equivalent to the Jackass crew.
Let's call Val Kilmer.
Oh, yeah, that'd be cool.
Okay. Val,
Yeah. Let's call Val. Okay, so
310, yeah. It's the gratuitous name dropping that makes me feel really, you know, like.
People like that, though.
You know who will call next?
People like name dropping.
Yeah, I know, totally.
I realize that.
That's what ups your value as a commodity.
Wait.
That was, you know, it's just like some fucking.
Your call has been forwarded to an automated voice message system. 3108.
Is my mic muted?
Yeah, it was.
Okay. Oh, yeah. We're talking to Val's voicemail.
Hey, Val, how you doing? It's Tom Green here and Steve-O. We're on the air right now. And just wanted to, we were trying to get you to
join us on a rap track.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, Val could
I don't
rap.
Know if Val's that big of a rapper.
He's a singer. Are these screwdrivers? Anyways.
You found vodka? Man, I feel like a loser. I can't get anybody more famous than me on the phone.
We're still on the answering machine with
Val. Oh, yeah, yeah. Hey, Val, yo, dude, fucking call. You want to call Andy Dick?
Yeah, let's call. Yeah. All right. I mean, it's, you know.
Yeah.
It's not Val Kilmer, but, you know, it'll do. Hey, Val, we'll call you later. Peace.
Okay, we're good. I'm thinking that you're punching.
I'm just joking. We love Andy Dick here.
Yeah, he's always here.
Do you hang with Andy?
So I bump into him, and it's always such a memorable experience.
He is awesome. Okay, wait.
I think you might have one. Oh, yeah. Next, we'll call Slater.
Did I screw that up? Is it Andy? You're watching the National Global Vision. Andy?
Yeah.
Hey, it's Steve-O and Tom Green here.
Are you guys on fucking TV?
Yeah, we're on. Well, yeah, we're on the Webovision right now.
Well, stay tuned because I'm this big black bitch is playing Deal or No Deal. I'm sorry, I've never seen the show, and now I'm addicted to it. See?
Hey, Andy. What's it gonna take for me and Tom to kick you off the wagon again?
Buddy, I'm already drinking.
Yeah! Okay, you know, like, okay, did you see the fucking, Andy, have you ever seen the Breaking Bonaducci show?
What about it? I've seen...
Fucking classic, you know? And now I'm gonna tear down my Danny Bonaducci poster and put up a Tom Sizemore poster. Fucking love that guy.
Sizemore's fucking show is awesome. That's
my God.
Now, what's that show all about?
We should have a little show. It should be Green, Dick, and Steve-O.
Where are you? Why don't you drive over here tomorrow? What are you doing tomorrow?
Why don't I come over right now? What's your fucking...
Let's do it, dude. Fuck,
how far
man.
Away? Well, I was thinking, how far away are you?
I could be up there in 20 minutes or less, you dumbass.
Come on
Let's
up.
Fucking do it. Hey, man.
Come on up right now. We'll stay on the air. You know, we're already 20 minutes over
dude,
on the
dude,
show.
Dude, we are not going fucking anywhere until you get here, Andy Dick, bro, Holmes, dude, buddy, right. Pal, amigo.
Oh, she lost it.
Oh, my God. Plus, we're already, like, half in the bag already. Dude,
yeah, get up
get
here.
Wasted.
Get up here. I mean, you're watching Deal or No Deal, for crying out loud.
And when the chunk of puss gets to the airport, maybe I'll tell her to fucking... I told her hop in a cab like a real gentleman.
Yeah.
I'll have that fucking cab come here, dude, and we will get plastered all night long.
Okay, yeah. No, absolutely.
You in, Andy?
Yeah.
All right, brother man, dude. Let's do it.
I understand. The big black girl just...
Oh, yeah. Bring that shit, dude.
No, he's watching Deal or No Deal in the
I thought he was saying that he had a big black girl like sucking on his dong.
No, the African American woman on the.
All right, well here we're gonna keep you on the line, give you directions, dude.
No, Andy knows how to get. You know how to get here, remember, Andy?
Yes, I do. Yes.
All right, we'll see you.
Okay, well come on up here because we're on the air now. We've been on for an hour and 20 minutes, but we're gonna just stay on now.
I'm gonna see if my friend can drive me up there.
Dude, don't give us any of that backpedaling bullshit.
You will drive up there.
A commitment is a commitment.
Tell us now if you're coming, cause we're gonna wait for you.
We have fans that are fucking dying to see you.
He said, yeah.
Oh, really?
All right, man. Well, then fucking we'll see you in a minute, brother. I'll ask.
Okay.
Bye.
Awesome.
Yeah. All right. Now let's try and get Christian Slater over here too. Oh my God, dude. Like. We can have a train wreck off.
Oh my God.
I owe Christian Slater an apology too because
I
told the story about the cops tasering him off the roof. Okay, I go 310.
I want him to tell. Christian Slater.
Enjoy the music while your party is reached.
Is that what he's up to these days?
It's just, you know.
Jesus Christ, not.
Not the hippest song.
He got drunk, all of a sudden he started hitting on me. Seemed like, you want to fight? Why are you so sexy?
He's just messing with you, I guess. No, wait.
Hello?
Hello, is Christian there?
No, wrong number.
Oh, dude.
Really, who's this?
I'm gonna start.
Who's this here?
Oh, man.
Why did I dial the wrong number? I didn't dial the wrong number. Maybe he didn't give you his actual number.
No, dude, because that number's been good fucking even after I threw his fucking BlackBerry in the pool.
Threw his what in the pool?
His BlackBerry. I threw it right in the goddamn pool.
Why'd you do that?
Because he fucking was disrespectful.
The time now is 9:22.
Right, let's get Ron Jeremy over here.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that'd be funny.
Okay, here we go.
Okay. We are live here from Los Angeles. You're watching live. We are... Okay. We're calling Ron Jeremy right now.
He's my bro.
It was Steve-O. And you can call us. If you go to tomgreen.com, the number is right at the bottom of the screen. We're on Mania TV.
Oh.
Hey, Ron.
Hi.
Hey, it's Tom Green here calling with Steve-O.
Really?
Yeah, we're
up. Yeah, dude. What up, Ron, bro, man?
Hey, what are you guys doing?
Hey, dude, we need you to come over to Tom Green's house, and we got to talk about how much we love PETA, and, you know, and how, like, wearing fucking fur sucks.
Hey, Ron, it's Tom here. We're on the air. I do this little web show in my living room here.
And,
is it Merrill or Labs?
It's a lot of fun, Andy Dick's on his way over right now.
I love him. Yeah. I've been
me and Steve-O, we're sitting here. We're taking calls from around the world. How are you tonight? What are you doing tonight?
Right now I'm at P.F. Chang's at a restaurant with a bunch of great people.
Oh, cool.
That's his way of saying a lot of fucking hot-ass sluts. But, am I right?
I'm a Siren at Evan Stone right now. I'm having a dinner at P.F. Chang's at the Galleria.
Oh, okay. Well, you know, you should come by the Webovision sometime.
Yeah, dude, Ron, bro, man, dude, like, honestly, he's the funniest. Like he's got narcolepsy, he just passes out, like, it's fucking awesome, dude. We can get him over here.
I can't even believe I'm talking to Ron. Now, I met you once very briefly in Toronto at the top of some stairs. You were standing with Mark Breslin. It was probably about...
Right. I also met you briefly when you and Drew were at Jay Leno. You did a routine where you faint. On the ground, you're going, here's a deer caught in the headlights, and you fainted.
Oh, yeah, that's right, yeah. Well, you've got to come by and do my my television show here I'm doing on the internet now.
I'd love to.
It's fun. It's a lot of fun. It'd be right up your alley.
And I met Drew a couple of times, but that was because...
We don't talk about her on the show, though.
Okay.
Yeah. No, that's bullshit. We talk about her as much as possible.
The
problem was that she was a lesbian.
Well, I was...
I don't know if that's actually the problem, but...
I consulted Boogie Nights, you know, with a small Thomas Anderson directed.
Yeah.
With Reynolds. And the one we can't talk about was up for a park. I was at a screening of one of his films that I was at.
Yeah.
And I kept falling asleep. And his agent at UTA going, Ron, you're making your friend look bad. He keeps falling asleep during his movie, you know?
Yeah.
They're showing Hard Eight, you know, or...
Wow. So wait, where are you right now?
P.F. Chang's. Restaurant at the Galleria and Sepulveda and...
So right now, like, you know, we're live on the internet right now.
I know.
So essentially right now, people around Los Angeles, we only probably have about 3 or 4 viewers in Los Angeles, could start driving towards P.F. Chang's right now and come see you out,
yeah,
just
hey,
so you know.
Hey, Ron, is it safe to say that you are going to fuck someone in that restaurant?
I got a shot.
Will you do that for me, Ron?
I'll let you hear it. Let me ask my friend here. Honey...
We're on the phone right now with Ron Jeremy. Andy Dick is on his way over here. I'm here with Steve-O, and we're sitting in my living room.
Okay. Then there's
Tom
this
Green.
Girl that I made love to.
Pretty good so far. No.
That should be a promo.
She's great looking.
All right, well, hey, yo, Ron, dude, let's catch up real soon, brother.
All right, man, it's great hearing from you, Steve.
Yeah, we'll track you down. It'd be great to have you by the channel sometime in the next couple of weeks.
Get my number from Steve-O.
I will.
Great, Tom.
Awesome, thanks, man. Right. Cheers, bye.
Okay, so you...
Ron Jeremy on the phone.
We gotta try Steve-O.
Can we key his name up on the screen? Just, I know he's not there anymore, but... Show Bill how to do that. Show young Snitzer how to do
that. You had to have dialed this wrong, dude. Try Tommy Lee again. I think you dialed it wrong.
Okay. That was.
I mean, he changed his number all the time, man, but...
I think we're making some Webovision history right now.
I know, dude. Basically, what we're doing is we're conceding the fact that we're washed-up has-beens. We're trying to call people who are still hot.
No, what are you talking about? Speak for me, maybe. But you were on the number one movie in America a couple of weeks ago.
Nah, dude.
I'm doing a show in my living room.
Yeah, but you've got more talent than I do. Come on, dude. Make it happen, dude. We need Tommy Lee.
Sir? Snitzer's got me covered. Okay.
Dude, come on. Fucking...
Is there vodka in this, or is this just straight orange juice?
We might have Tommy right here, but he would never answer.
Tommy
never
Lee? Know. And if we get Tommy Lee and Andy Dick and Ron Jeremy and you and I up here.
Hey, Andy, let's have a celebrity party. Man, I think I'm getting drunk a little bit.
This isn't too strong, though, I don't think.
Ah, man. Maybe pour some teal in there, too.
Dave, leave a message.
Dude, you called Super Dave, dude.
What's your message after
how did I dial the wrong one?
It's a major drug dealer, dude. Oh.
Nice to meet you.
Okay, look, dude. Come on, dude.
I swear that's what I called.
Well, then.
No, I'll try it again. T-bone, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm definitely calling T-bone. Sure, that time. You may be right. I may have misdialed. I am.
I know, making me look like a jerk.
No, I may have misdialed. Hey, I'm prone for error. Prone to error. Dig.com is the best website on the planet, by the
maybe
way.
Maybe we should, like.
Thanks for coming down to the show. Tell us a little bit more about
Dig.com. Hey, what's up? It's Tommy. Leave me a message. I'll get back to you as soon as I can.
See, dude? Now I feel like less than a fucking douchebag.
Yeah, I obviously misdialed. That was Tommy Lee.
Record your message after the tone.
Yeah, okay, well, dude, let's do a wrap.
Hi.
Okay, hold on.
Finished recording.
I'll tell him
hang up.
This.
Or for delivery options, press pound.
Yeah.
Hey, Tommy, it's Tom Green and Steve-O here.
Yeah,
we're
dude.
On the internet, and Steve-O wants to rap for you.
I'm with Tom Green. He's a rap machine.
Machine!
He won't tell anyone he smokes the green.
Green!
Snorts ketamine, chugs codeine.
Dean! You know what I mean?
Yeah. He's a drug-addled fucking maniac, dude. Tommy, bro, I don't know if you're still in Miami, but it's about time that we fucking... drank until our livers fell right out of our buttholes.
Hear, hear.
Woo! God, I feel like that was like redemption.
Yeah.
You know, like everybody heard that, Tommy
Lee.
Yeah.
Oh, new
person.
Hey,
I'm a huge fan. I'd love to bounce your ass off my cock, you little midget faggot.
Wait. Midget faggot?
Shithole, you fucking piece of shit.
All right, my IQ is significantly higher than yours. Please.
Do we want to hang up on this guy? Or do we want to like?
No, I want to hear why. Like, yeah. What's midget faggot?
Okay, we can hang up at any time. I'm just thinking it's funny to sometimes you realize that the sort of
yeah, it's not going.
People, no, I mean this guy's obviously actually probably a clever guy. I mean he realizes the only way to really do anything crazy is to just go
some
for the gut.
Some people would take infamy over obscurity.
Yeah.
You know, people would just rather be known as absolute shit dicks than unknown.
Yeah.
You know, so they just try and be assholes all the time.
God, I hate people like that.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay, let's call Kid Rock. All right, dude, you're not going to be... Okay, this one's going to be so fun. Okay.
Oh, it's cool. Bob Rock. TomGreen.com right now. Tom Green Live.
That cannot be completed as
yeah, dude, you forgot the last numbers.
How do I do that all the time?
You're bad at dialing numbers.
I really am. I was always bad at mathematics. Anything that involves numbers, I'm always really never been that great with. But let's see. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's clear.
Okay, dude, wait until you here's automated secretary.
Good morning. The number you've reached. 1-3-5. Please make a note of it.
Yeah, see, dude.
Hey, they're all changing their number on you.
I do it all the time myself. Can't blame anyone. You know what it's like to be a massive celebrity?
Yeah.
It's here. Yeah.
Do you have Pam's number?
Pam Anderson?
Yeah, you got Tommy and you got Kid Rock.
That's funny, dude. Like, you know, like, I gotta break the, like, you know, spill the beans. Like, Kid Rock refers to Tommy Lee as half a faggot, which I think is funny, you know.
I don't know.
But Tommy's my boy for fucking.
They've got personal drama, I guess, going on.
Yeah, if I had to pick sides, I would go with dude. Try K-Fed.
I don't think
again.
You have to choose.
Try K-Fed one more time, dude.
Yeah. Oh my God. I mean, come on. That would be the capper for sure. We could get him over here. We could lay down a track tonight.
I know.
Got this new 16-track Boss digital recorder.
Have we tried Slater? What happened to Slater?
We called him, but left a message. Did we leave a message? Or?
I can't fucking remember. Hey, let's try it again. I think that's going to get us
this K-Fed. Is K-Fed?
I think so.
K-Fed. Time is 9:32. You know, I love how you're the only guest we've ever gone over with.
That's good.
Even by a minute. Or no, we go over 10 minutes sometimes, but here we are a half hour in. Andy Dick's on his way over here. We're making some WebOvision history here tonight.
I know, we're calling every celebrity in my phone. So funny.
Wait, who's ringing now?
It's K-Fed, dude.
Oh, K-Fed, right.
You have reached the Sprint TCS voicemail box of 310.
Oh, see the way God. He is?
Wow.
Later.
Popular guy.
For calling. Goodbye.
Okay.
I heard today on CNN that he's got a big Super Bowl commercial
coming.
I
know, dude. How much cheddar you think he got for that?
Cool million.
You think?
Yeah, I think he got a cool million.
Okay, okay, dude. Let's go on to a new, funny, sorts of funny. Because I think I'm running out of celebrities.
Okay, yeah, we don't have to call anymore. Here's a source of funny. Herodora. What else? You know, let's take a call.
We are
still live on the internet. We are still live around the world here at TomGreen.com.
Oh wait, we have to call.
Andy Dick is on his way over. We're here with Steve-O.
We have
Stephen
to call
Glover.
This girl Robin from the real world.
I was
making love to her and.
Okay. Well.
Like in the hotel room, and like while she was on the TV screen.
We don't need to be so.
Well, she knows that she's heard about it.
We don't need to be so darned. This is filthy. This is Robin from the real world. From the which one? Las Vegas?
I can't even keep track. I don't know.
No, you. Been with a lot of real world girls, have you?
Hey, what's up? You reached Robin. I can't come to the phone right now, so leave me a
message. Oh, man. Because she would definitely attest to the fact that I'm fucking horrible in bed.
And have a great day.
Really?
Yeah.
Record your message.
Which year was she on the real world?
I don't know.
Five.
A couple years ago.
When you were finished recording, hang up.
We all know the popular show, The Real World, on MTV. Hello, Robin. How are you? This is Tom Green calling, and Steve-O, Stephen Glover.
Yeah, we were hoping to get you on the phone to confirm that I'm just a fucking lousy lover in bed, you know? can we give her a number to call?
I don't even know if...
I'm telling you, dude, one pump chump, dude.
I don't think this is an appropriate message.
All right, let's try Robin. Slater again. I'm just getting shit-faced, I love it.
Robin, I apologize for Steve-O's
very conditionally
outrageous words.
Oh yeah, Slater. So we gotta try Slater again because I think you're bad at dialing.
Yeah, no, I absolutely am.
Okay, 1-3-1-0.
I would just like to take a second to say hello to everybody at home watching.
Thanks.
Hey, Christian?
Press 5 now.
Oh, this is answering machine?
Yeah, I think, yeah, that's...
Christian Slater's answering machine.
If you are satisfied with your message...
Oh, is that a message? Oh. No, I'm not satisfied.
No, no,
that's
no.
2, to erase and press 3. At the tone, please re-record your message. At the end of your message, press 1.
Hey, Christian, it's Tom Green here. We just did one of those erase and re-record things.
Yeah, it's me, Steve-O, bro, dude. Hey, Slater, bro. I've got this wall in my apartment complex, and I want you and me running full speed at it, and we're going to have a biggest hole in the wall competition. I mean, I know that you're going to fucking love it, dude. It's going to be great.
Let's just set this up a little bit. We're on the internet
now. Yeah, we're actually broadcasting live. Like, on the internet.
On the internet right now, yeah. And Steve-O's here, and we thought you were going through Steve-O's cellular telephone.
Yeah. Like,
we're calling celebrities. We've called Tommy Lee. We've called...
Christian Slater's the biggest one, dude. Val Kilmer.
Yeah, Christian Slater.
Val Kilmer.
Who else? Yeah.
Ron Jeremy.
It's been... And Andy Dick is coming...
Andy Dick, yeah.
Andy Dick's the only one that answered the phone. He was watching Deal or No Deal.
Dude.
He was watching Deal or... What's... He's going to be here in 15 minutes.
Yeah. And so, dude.
So,
like,
Christian, if you know Christian Slater, you have to go see, if you love Christian Slater, you got to go see the movie Bobby that is in theaters now. He was great in it.
And I
saw it recently and loved it. But, Christian, come by the WebOvision. Steve-O is here, and we'll talk to you later. Christian Slater. Okay.
Yeah.
I wanted the message to make sense to him, you know. So the joke kind of...
You gotta stroke his ego a little bit. That's how it works.
No, it wasn't so much that.
Man, I forgot.
I just wanted it to sound professional.
Hey, dude, I forgot to bring weed, dude. But I remember I forgot that one doobie that I left here.
Oh, okay.
Like, can I get my doobie back? Can we send someone, like,
I have a feeling it may not be around anymore.
Whoa, hey. I'm not going to let you come out of the marijuana closet like that.
No. I mean, I'm a very conservative guy, to be honest with you. Kids, stay
on the drugs. Oh, yeah, you brought me a joint?
I'm a very conservative
guy. Can I smoke
weed? I'm not a drug user.
No. I like to smoke.
And
I like
I'm not
to
a big alcohol
weed.
User.
I mean, here's the deal, dude. Marijuana, it's like fucking, it makes everything better, you know? Like, everything better.
Doesn't it make you tired all day?
Well, horny, hungry, like, and tired.
It makes you horny?
Hungry and tired.
But doesn't that, like...
What do we have to do to continue our fucking species? We have to fucking rest, we gotta eat, and we gotta fuck. Horny, hungry, and tired, dude.
Yeah.
Woo! Yeah! H-H-T. Yeah, let's fire it up if you can... Yeah. Oh, bitch.
H-H-T.
Yeah.
Horny, hungry...
You know, I mean, like, I need to eat, it gives me the appetite. You know, I need to fuck, and it makes me horny, and I need my rest. I get tired. It's like fucking genius, dude. Yeah. You don't have to have AIDS or cancer to, like, fucking, for there to be medicinal value.
No.
That being said, I'm completely opposed. I'm completely opposed to all fucking attempts to legalize marijuana. I absolutely prefer it illegal. You know, who the fuck wants... You know, like...
Yeah, you want it to come into, like, in a package?
Totally.
You want commercials for it on TV?
If marijuana was legal, I wouldn't have been the cool dude for holding up that big bag of pot to get those cops suspended.
Yeah.
See?
Yeah.
I like breaking the law. Like, when...
You like to break the law.
I do. Like, I've been arrested for, like, more fucking shit.
You have?
Like,
really? I've never been arrested.
I've been arrested for international drug smuggling in Sweden.
Wait, how could you be here right now talking to me if you've been international drug smuggling?
Yeah.
Here right now?
Yeah.
Why aren't you, like, in Rikers Island right now, getting reamed in the ass?
Well, because it was, I took a condom, and I was in Norway. I filled a condom with marijuana, tied it in a knot.
I've heard about this, but I want to hear the story again on the WebOvision.
And swallowed it, and then I went to Sweden. I bragged to everyone. The cops read the newspaper. They're like, fuck this asshole. But I already shit it out and smoked it all. So I'm... crapping.
What was in the condom?
Marijuana and hash.
Okay, yeah.
And
but you talked about it.
My actual charge?
So you swallowed a condom filled
in Norway
with marijuana and hash.
In Norway.
You actually did this.
Right, in Norway.
Oh,
is that Andy Dick?
Andy Dick's here. Andy Dick's here.
Yeah.
No? But, who is it?
Do you know I had this fucking... Fuck the condom full of weed bullshit. Everybody knows that. I saw fucking Andy Dick at the MTV Movie Awards, and, like, he was on fire. You know how he gets.
Oh, he's awesome.
You know how he gets.
Always awesome.
Yeah, Then, and I was so drunk myself that I actually proposed to him. I said, hey, let's do a publicity stunt. Like, we're gonna go around town and fucking make out in public, you and me, Andy Dick, until we get paparazzi coverage, and then it'll be like, think of all the press we'll get.
Like,
no?
You guys were like a couple. Like an Anne Hesh, Ellen DeGeneres kind of deal.
Because I'm a fucking media whore, dude. Like, that's how it works.
You and Andy Dick could be the next Anne Hesh and Ellen DeGeneres.
I was thinking I could get a lot of press if I fucking, like, came
that's
out
how Ellen DeGeneres got her talk show.
Do you think it's creepy?
With the Anne Hesh rumor.
Let's say someone like holding a gun to your head. You had a deep tongue kiss, either me or Andy Dick. Which would be the creepier kiss?
With what?
You had, like, your choice, you know, like, you're a gun to your head.
Okay.
You have to deep tongue kiss.
I wanted to clarify. You're asking me now, if I had a gun to my head and
you
I
had
to choose...
kiss, French kiss, either me or Andy Dick. You'd go for me, right?
With a gun to my head?
Well, yeah. Like they're saying, you have no choice in the matter. You're gonna fucking French kiss one of us. You have to, like one or the other, me or Andy.
So my choice is a bullet in the head or kissing a dude.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, a bullet in the head is pretty much what it amounts to. Like,
you know what? I'm gonna answer you honestly.
You wouldn't want to play favorites, so you're gonna do it with both of us.
No. Honestly, I would pick you.
Yeah.
Yeah. Honestly, I would pick you if I really had to choose between death or kissing.
Well, I mean, it is potentially death.
No, because I think I would have a feeling that you were kind of doing it more for a joke, whereas Andy might actually sort of like that kind of stuff.
Right.
So I'd rather be doing it for a joke.
All right.
And not getting shot in the head.
But unfortunately for you, to make the joke funny, I would really, really fucking lay it on you.
Yeah, but you—it's just a joke, though. Then.
Yeah.
That's just like sucking milk out of a cow's udder, you know. It's like, it doesn't really matter.
Okay. Yeah, so
it's disgusting. It's disgusting, right, but so, it's just, you know.
How about this? Either Andy Dick has to give you a blowjob, or you have to give Andy Dick a blowjob. I'd have to consult Dr. Drew on that one. I'm thinking he'd have to suck my dick.
So wait, what?
See, now the show's warming up, dude.
What's the choice again?
Sometimes it takes.
By the way,
by the way,
Andy Dick is coming tonight, so.
Yeah, I'm telling you, that's goddamn right. I'll have him coming.
No. It's disgusting. It's a filthy thing.
I didn't have to think of all the press that could be involved in this.
No, come on. You gotta draw the line at some point. Goddamn it.
I'm just dying to get Tom Cruise out of the closet, you know, like fucking, and be faithful to him.
What do you mean?
You know, because there's a lot of fucking press that I could get out of that.
What are you talking about?
Imagine if fucking me and Tom Cruise came pirouetting out of the closet.
Are you saying you're in a relationship with...
No, but I'm saying I'm not gay whatsoever, but like I know there's enough press in it to make it worthwhile to fucking exclusively date Tom Cruise and be faithful to him.
Yeah, you're like basically like a Kate Hudson or whatever.
I am a fucking...
What's her name? Katie Holmes.
Yeah.
You're like the male Katie Holmes.
I know, dude. Haven't fucking the tabloids been just having an easy... All these tabloid people, their jobs have been so easy lately. Fucking Nicole Richie's driving the wrong way down a freeway. Mike Tyson's got a car full of fucking cocaine.
I don't know if I get it anymore, to be honest with you. I think it's just a bunch of people like us fucking around who are in the media. So then I start to get really scared.
And back to my arrest record.
I start to get scared because I think if the media consists of a bunch of people like us fucking around, then there's like no checks and balances. We're basically in a society that's spiraling out of control.
Oh my God, dude. You know? Definitely, dude. Definitely. And then take this fucking asshole, the prison break guy who fucking killed the kid. Right? Like, he crashed the car, the Garrison dude, whatever.
Which one's this here?
I don't know who the fuck he is. I just know he killed the 15-year-old kid in his car or something. Like, vehicular manslaughter, now that's a drag.
Yeah.
But,
being
busted with 15-year-old high school kids who are you know, I mean, come on. What the guy?
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah, well, I'm sure Andy Dick can tell us a little bit about that.
I know. I hope he doesn't sit. Dude, that's fucking when you know you're washed up, like when you're bummed out that Andy Dick stood you up. You think, but that's, and he's got a thriving career.
He won't stand us up.
He better not.
No. He'll be here.
I feel like we really were warming up just then, and now I feel like we're cool. We got to fucking get
you
hot.
Felt, really. You felt a change in momentum there?
That kind of, yeah, dude, kind of. What, like, what's it gonna take right here to heat this shit up, dude? Fucking, let's see that one nut.
No, it's not gonna happen. It's not gonna happen.
Come on, break out the uni ball.
No, I'm.
Let's take a call.
Yes. Hello, you're on the air.
Hey, you guys, I was wondering, would you do that puck?
Wait, what?
Would you two be able to stand up and slapbox?
Oh, I thought you were gonna ask if we were gonna butt fuck, you know, like.
No, not butt fuck. You know.
It's not really, but you're not fucking a butt.
Like when
you have a condom on, what you're doing is you're fucking a condom, and there's just a butt in your butt.
When I get drunk, I want to fight somebody, and you guys look pretty wasted. So, could you guys please slapbox? You know, just.
No.
No, dude, talk about negative energy, man. You know that's a fucking.
That, I think that's got to be like kind of like a thing of the past. A thing of the past, right? Hello, you're on the air.
Oh, okay. I was just wondering, Steve-O, can you tell me how to shot web, please?
Can I tell you how to shot web?
Yes, please. How do I shot web?
What the fuck is shot web?
Just tell me how to do it, please.
Who the fuck is this?
Did I get him right? Shot web?
Yeah, it's some internet prank they're doing. Hello, you're on the air.
Yeah, I want to know what Steve-O's shirt says.
Oh, it says destruction made simple. It says like a little band.
That's actually a good question. Can we see it? Can you show it?
Oh, yeah.
I like that. That's the best question of the night. Destruction made simple. Yeah. It's a band. Okay. Thanks for your call. Hello, you're on the air.
Hey, Tom, I had a question for Steve-O.
Yeah? You talk to him recently? Yeah, you sure? Yeah, let's call Steve.
Nah, don't harass this bag ass.
Yeah, hey, who's this?
Well, I got a question for you.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. Ask Steve-O the question.
Lay it down, bro.
Hey, what kind of weed do you like? What strain of weed do you like?
You know, dude, there's two kinds of weed where I come from, pal. Good and bad. All right, good weed, dude.
You talked about, Kush. When you rap last time,
Yeah, that's because it rhymed with fuck George Bush.
So, I mean, do you like smoking Kush or hazes?
You know, there's always some new snazzy term for fucking marijuana, dude. Right. Like, Kush, like, you know, fucking dank or, you know, like, whatever. Fucking, there's good, there's bad, you know. There's a kind of kind.
We really shouldn't be smoking this on the air. Let me get rid of this here. This should not be smoked on the air here. Obviously, we're looking for advertisers and stuff. Keep talking to Steve-O.
Hey, Steve-O, one more question.
Yeah, dude.
Hey, are you...
Sorry, bro.
Still doing nitrous?
Nah, dude. I really left that in my past. I mean, I don't know, like, if it's gonna...
Doing nitrous?
Well, yeah, nitrous doesn't even fucking do shit to me anymore. It just makes me fucking an idiot.
So you quit already?
Yeah, like, yeah, dude, totally, man. I'm really focusing more on, ketamine, ecstasy, GHB, fucking, what else, man? Like, there's all kinds of fucking fun drugs. Like, you know, maybe I'll revisit LSD. That was always a lot of fun.
You do
get rid of that cigarette there. You shouldn't be smoking that on the air. That's disgusting.
Special K, do you do mushrooms?
Nah, dude, mushrooms make me really introspective, you know? Like,
absolutely, get rid of that.
I analyze myself when I'm on mushrooms. I always, like, just arrive at the conclusion that I suck, you know?
Or the hey, enough of this drug talk. We don't want drugs on
this
show.
Yeah, totally.
Drugs are bad. No drugs. Drugs are bad. Hello, you're on the air.
Hey, what's up, Tom?
Hey, how are you?
Doing good. How you doing, man?
Doing really
good. How's the show, like, compared to, like, the last time I was here?
Oh, man, how do you know when the last time you were there? I didn't see that.
But it's, like, pretty entertaining fucking shit, right?
Yeah, what smoking?
What? Wait, what?
It's prop cigar tobacco.
Oh, yeah. All right.
We're
big in the rap game. We're just trying to, like, pull a little prank on the fucking hip-hop.
It's to maintain sort of an image of unpredictability.
Right? Yeah, I mean, the FBI has an entire hip-hop division, and we're pretty much, like, the most dangerous fucking shit on it.
Yeah.
Yeah, keeping it real, man.
You know, yeah.
What are you guys drinking right now?
I don't know, dude. Check out how fucking far ahead of me you fucking got your jerk.
What do we got around here, anyways? What's going on? Whiskey.
I'm telling you, dude, this is MacGyver fucking cocktail lounge. Is like.
It's a little tequila. That's tequila and vodka.
I know. It's fucking whatever.
Damn, you're fucking. Yeah.
So wait, you're on the air right now. This is your moment to shine.
Here, hold on, dude. I got this one.
Oh my. Really? Wait. Dim the lights. Goddammit. We want to get this. Dim the lights.
I don't know if I have it.
Dim the goddamn lights. This
Jesus
is important.
Jesus fucking Christ. I just farted. Man, it stinks too. You see, it's polite to ignite, dude. How did I really ignite it?
It is polite to ignite.
Yeah, but unfortunately, I didn't light it.
Hey, so do you want to say something, or?
What's up, Steve-O? What's up to Tom?
Hey, man. What's your name?
My name's Matt. What's your name?
Where are you calling from, Matt?
From Los Angeles, California.
Oh, yeah? What part of Los Angeles are you in?
Huntington Park.
Huntington Park, okay.
Yeah.
You grew up here?
No, I grew up in Torrance.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's basically Los Angeles, though, right? My dog Steve is from Torrance.
Do a little beatbox
for me. You wanted to bust a rhyme?
Yeah.
You know what I'd like to say, actually, Steve, although while we're on the topic, if you really want to bust a rhyme, well, hey, Robert, why don't you go put a camera out in the back house by my new keyboard?
And why don't we make this internet broadcast a little more boring? Come on, just beatbox.
I'm just saying, at some point, yeah, you know, you'll have. I could make a beat for you.
Let me make it
hard on the air and light your fire away.
Now let me make this clear. I'll fucking wait. Oh, no, I missed a beat. I'm sorry.
Yeah. I'll come in.
Okay.
I'll come in under you. You start.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let me make this clear. I will clap you in the ear. I'm a tough fucking asshole when I drink enough beer. I get completely wasted every day of the year. About making money, I am sincere. And this guy's not making us any money.
You gotta hear this new keyboard, you're not gonna understand. It's unbelievable. Hello, you're on the air.
Do you see the way that I'm flowing now, dude? Like, every time I come back here, dude, it's like...
This is Colin from Queens, New York.
Yeah, Queens, New York, on the air. It's 9:53 here in Los Angeles. We're with Steve-O, and we've got a caller on the air from Queens, New York.
Yeah.
What's your name?
Let's make it snappy, because I'm feeling rappy. I need you to try to make me happy. See, I freestyled that just then.
Yeah, no, it was dope.
Yeah, dope.
I wanted to hear the freestyle, too.
Yeah, hey, Tom's a fucking freestyle machine, man. The first time I heard him fucking flow like that, I was so intimidated, I almost thought about
I can rap all day, I can rap all night, and if you don't like it, then you're in for a fight.
He can rap all day, and he sure is gay. But I kind of like him that way. Step into beat again.
Yeah. Now, are you a rapper yourself, sir?
How fucking gay can
I used to play around in high school. Before we graduated, we used to hang out, you know, smoke weed all the time. I really appreciate what Steve said, you know what I mean? Before, he was really right on that when he was like, you know, it's better kids, like, just go out and hang out instead of, you know, just hanging in all day, you know?
Yeah, watching video games, playing video games all day.
Yeah, fuck yeah, dude, man. Like, here's the deal. Here's the problem with video games, man. They require, like, a lot of fucking time and effort.
Yo,
and fucking, like, you know, sitting on sofa and getting fat. And fucking, like, at the end of the day, what have you accomplished? What bitch is gonna suck your dick because you finished Tekken 3?
What bitch? What bitch?
Like, where does that get? I mean, you know, like, at least practice juggling or something. No. You know, like, show a bitch how you can juggle. Maybe she'll suck your dick.
Bitch, then.
Playing video games not gonna make that happen.
And I'm actually lucky because I actually graduated, you know what I mean?
Hey, dude, you sound like a rapper, dude. Are you a rapper?
Yeah. I used to freestyle a little bit.
All right. Why don't you join in, dude? Get us kicking on something. Maybe we can fucking jump in on it.
All right, for sure, man, for sure.
What do you got?
All right, I'm just gonna start rapping, yo, and then you guys just...
Yeah, fucking asshole, we need that. Let's do it.
And plus, I want Tom Green to do the beat again.
Okay, check it. I'll come in under you, okay?
Yo. Filling up the valley stream, oh shit, it's not a dream. I'm just busting the rhyme like easy as it seems. And plus, I'll be chilling with up in my jeans. But I don't want to say it, because family might be watching please. I'm just an indie rapper, indeed. I'm rapping with Tom Green, be with Steve Bowe. It's the craziest, don't you know? You can't touch the flow. This is, like, unbelievable, yo. I want to hear Steve O kick the bomb and then pass it to Tom Green. One mother, to arm.
Queens, New York.
No, he says he's passing it to you, asshole. Now you freestyle.
My name is Tom Green. When I rhyme, I write. when you want to hear my rhyme, you're in for a fight.
So, okay, dude, dude, Tom, that wasn't that great, but I'm not gonna hate. I came here to appreciate the rhymes that I flow. Have to know that we're gonna go, like, do better than that. See, like, that, if that was a freestyle war, then I would have just won, right?
Seriously, I just want to say, yo, you guys are the best entertainers in the business, you know what I mean?
Thank you very much. You know, your opinion is shared by many.
Definitely, and, you know what I mean? I want to end the call on a freestyle note, then. And...
All right, man. See, yeah, dude. And by the way, let me compliment you, man. Like, a lot of people, I watched that White Rapper show on VH1.
With MC Search,
garbage,
right?
Dude.
MC Search?
Dude, all their talent put together can't fuck with me.
MC Search, one of the great...
This guy's good, man. I was
MC
impressed
MC Search,
with that.
One of the great MCs of all time.
Hey, dude, big ups on fucking the way you handle that, dude. Like, that was genuine freestyle, like, and it was good shit, man.
But seriously, I also wanted to say, too, yo, the Jackass thing, unbelievable. Tom Green, Freddie Got Fingered, all of the movies.
Hey, dude, our careers are legit.
Yep.
You know, like...
Yep.
Absolutely. We're not talking shit. Smoking marijuana, we will not quit.
Yo, the skateboarding too, man. I really gotta say, yo, that's one of the deadliest videos is when you was on the...
On the butthole I spit to get my cock in it.
Butthole!
Hey, man, you know, like, being showered with accolades sure is awesome, man, but, like, hey, dude, like, just great job on the rap, dude, and thanks a lot, man. Like, we know that we're awesome. You're never gonna be as big of a fan of me as I am, but like, you know, so let's just leave it to me to say I'm the fucking man, and it was great to rap with you, bro.
Queens, New York.
Thanks, man. Yeah, Queens, New York.
Yeah, dude.
All right, peace.
Big it up, big it up.
Peace, Queens, New York, in the house. What's up? Hello, hello. You're on the air. That was dope, though. That was dope. Him rhyming and the beatbox.
I know, dude. We all did it together, dude.
That was like the first.
See, here's the truth. Sorry to interrupt you.
Yep. No.
You know, like, I'm not from the hood, but I rap pretty good. I don't come from the street, but my rhymes are complete. You know, when I grab the microphone, it is always a treat. And fucking don't mess with me, cause I'm packing heat.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah.
You know who I'm really impressed by is Fergie.
Oh, from the
Fergie.
Yeah, just you got a little.
Ain't no
you got a little.
Woman laid down like that. You know, like when you fucking, she's got me, dude.
From the Black Eyed Peas.
Yup. You know, like yeah, Fergie, dude. Yeah.
You have a little crush? Do you have a little crush on her?
Shit, yeah, dude. Put it this way, dude. If I can get my fucking face fully fucking buried between her ass cheeks, I would not stop licking, pal. You know what I mean? And, like, truth be told, no woman is ever gonna ask a man to lick her asshole like that. But,
I don't,
damn well no woman's gonna tell him to stop.
I don't even know what.
You know?
I don't even know what.
It's not even, okay, the chick starts licking your asshole.
Yeah.
Or you're like, ooh, I don't do that.
Yeah, yeah.
Sometimes I get a little creepy, you know, but it's like, you know, what you gotta do is pretend that you don't notice.
Yeah.
You know, I just like, let it ride.
Yeah, no, I kind of,
See, now we're back in the groove, dude. Boom. Next, let's take a call.
Hello, you're on the air.
Yeah, hey, what's up, Steve-O? Yeah, Tom, so what if you have a new rap album coming out?
Steve-O needs to hear you flow, or I'll make fun of you like you don't know. Your talent is not showing signs of growth.
Literal box.
Hello, you're on the air.
Hi, have you guys...
What can you say that won't sound gay? My time fucking is money, so don't ruin my day.
Hello?
Hey, how are you? Where are you calling from?
I'm from New Jersey.
Awesome.
I'm wondering, have you guys ever been on Amazon.com?
Amazon.
Are you asking how many units we've moved through the fucking,
Have you guys... review the Tuscan Milk on Amazon and also NEDM.
Dude, can you please fucking rap? Jesus Christ, can't people realize this is freestyle time? That's what's gonna make the show hot.
That's true. You must know Exhibit. You've probably run into him.
I'd love that fucking
He was over here rhyming the other day.
No, I don't know well enough for him to give me his cell phone number.
We gotta call him up. Zach Wolk, good exhibit over here.
Here, dude, let me get you some emergency.
No, don't bug him tonight in the middle of the night, but we should get him over here.
Yeah. Hey, dude, Tom, dude, I just want you to know I genuinely fucking enjoy this shit, dude.
Yeah, no, honestly, Steve-O, I want to say I really, really appreciate you coming and by the channel.
Dude, I gotta say, makes me grow as a performer, dude. Like, all this freestyle, dude, this is what I need to be doing. I need my head in the fucking game, dude.
Well, I appreciate you coming by time and time again, because people love it when you're here. People love it when you're here, and
it's a lot of fun, dude. It takes us an hour to warm up sometimes.
Yeah.
You know, boom, hello.
No, I love it.
And I mean, I want everyone to know that just because we're in overtime doesn't even mean that we're making a dime.
Yeah, it does.
We're in overtime, we're not making a dime. The fucking hell, dude. Eating a sour pussy could use some lime, like.
You know what we're saying, ma'am.
Yeah.
Where are you calling from?
Jersey.
Yeah, I won't call you ma'am because I don't give a damn. You know, like, I'd rather make out with the dude from Wham.
Wham.
George Michael, that is. Hey, what do you got? Let's feel the please hear it and rap.
When are you putting out your rap CD?
When am I putting out my rap CD? Well, that's pretty hard to fucking
be.
Hard to be. Well, can you not see that I'm fucking rehearsing right now, dude? And if you're not rapping with me, then you're fucking completely distracting me from my rehearsal. Jesus Christ. Can
bitch.
We get a freestyler on the phone?
Bitch. Bitch.
Yeah. No. That bitch makes my herpes itch.
No. Nice girl. Oh. Hello, you're...
Yo, Philly in the house.
Wait, what happened?
Let's not wake people up in the middle of the night. It's getting late now. It's getting late.
No, it's Hello. Not.
Well,
oh,
okay.
Shit.
We'll call Jurassic.
Too late. Hey, why don't you guys call Andy back? I think he dicked you over.
Is Andy dicking us over?
Yeah, that didn't rhyme either.
Call him back. Let's call him back in a cell right now. Let's call him right now, see if he's on his way.
I already need you need me to fucking...
Yeah, let's get done. Let's just call him.
Yeah, dude, let's work on an ETA.
We're here with Steve-O right now. You're watching Tom Green Live. This show airs every night on tomgreen.com. That's this channel here on the internet. You can do television now on the internet.
Let's get an
tell
ETA
your friends.
From the
press
dudes
the yellow button
gay.
And tell your friends. Speak to them. Call them on the phone and say, you can watch television on the internet now. Last night I called and talked to Steve-O for about 45 minutes. Tell them how you did it, where you went, how it worked. You'd be really helping me out, to be honest with you. You'd be really helping me out. Yeah. Okay.
Andy Dick is being a prick. If he doesn't get here lightning quick, I'm going to take a stick.
Ka-ka. Wait.
Yeah, we got him. Yeah, Andy. Andy,
we're on the air. Go to your computer.
Yeah, Jesus Christ. Yeah,
this is what we're stretching right now.
Are you in the fucking car? No, we're not stretching shit, dude. We're actually getting better and better.
No, we are getting, we're getting better. We're getting warmed up for you. Sick as that sounds. What's that? Okay, get on over here, Andy.
Hey, Andy, dude, if you stick us, stand us up, dude, you're out of luck,
Look.
Dude. I'll fucking...
Fuck you
fuck
up.
Fuck you up, yeah, dude. I know you will, dude. That's what I'm worried about.
Okay, come on.
All right. Jesus.
My God. Christ. Look at this bling. Now, is this aftermarket? Is this actual? These actual diamonds here as well, Steve?
No, dude. Those ones are, You know, dude, here's my question, dude. This Leonardo DiCaprio movie. Dude,
yeah, about the diamonds.
About diamonds.
Yeah.
Is this gonna, like, fucking ruin the rap world? Like, are diamonds gonna become uncool
because of this movie? I saw... Russell Simmons on the Fox News Channel defending the diamonds.
Because, man, I look at my Rolex and I'm like, ooh, like, am I, like, fucking party fouling with my fucking...
I saw Russell Simmons defending the diamond industry because he says it brings a lot of money into African countries that mine diamonds. So I don't think it's you know, I think there's a negative aspect to the diamond industry. There is some controversy there, but at the end of the day, bling, I think, is good.
Shit, yeah.
Support Bling. Support Steve-O's Bling.
I know, I hear you, bro, dude.
Yeah.
Dude, this freestyle, this is actual legitimate freestyle, right? Like, a lot of this kid, when I'm doing my thing, I write the fucking, it's all scraps paper, and then, like, once I have it, like, I write it clean on, like, one page, and then it's like I try to, like, hide the page, like, as if it wasn't there, like, to create the impression that I'm freestyling, you know?
Yeah.
It's like, dude, we are legitimately freestyling.
Yeah. You know? Right now.
Like,
Yeah, but you don't have to hide the page,
laying,
though.
We're laying.
You don't have to hide the page. You can kind of freestyle.
No, but that's the thing, dude. Like, you know, that I wrote.
Have you
wrote
recorded a lot of songs yet for this album?
Well, the thing is, dude, Universal Records are totally bummed on the fact that I fucking leaked the shit out there. They're like, dude, you've got to start writing fucking rap lyrics and fucking keeping them, like, on lockdown, dude, because people are, you know. I disagree, though, because, like, what people are getting on the internet right now, it's like rough practice time. It's like,
yeah,
they're gonna want to know because 50 Cent's DJ is producing my entire album.
Really?
Yeah.
Is probably he in Los Angeles?
Call up United.
Are you gonna record any of the album here?
I was rolling around Manhattan and Who Kid.
But can
Lambo
we come to the studio with the Webo Vision cameras and film you in the studio?
We'll call Who Kid, dude.
It's called Who Kid right now.
And I like.
But it would be cool if, when you're doing some recording, to come into the studio with the National Webovision cameras here from, bring Robert. Robert, are you quitting? Yeah, whoever is the replacement.
Dude, like, it's just wild, man, like, when we actually freestyle. Like, I mean, you're, like, rhyming, you're thinking about it really is pretty gnarly.
Yeah. So, I've always get a little nervous freestyling.
I know, me too, dude. Like,
plus, you don't know what you're going to say next.
Of, like, you know, like, this is live, dude.
Yeah, no, we're on the live Webo Vision.
This is
like
live
television. If you don't like it, you need better vision.
Okay, we got it's a voicemail, dude.
Okay, wait a minute.
Dude. Yeah, because I did.
This is awesome. This is what Webo Vision's all about. I want to say this right now. I want to say this right now, for the record, on the National Webo Vision, to all the people watching.
Hey, Tom Green and Steve-O coming at you, Who Kid. I'm the wildest, the baddest, Wisconsin's are the raddest, the roll blunts of fattest,
what?
Middle name's Madness.
What?
Yeah,
your middle name is actually Madness?
I'm out of my mind. Tom Green's going to be on our album, Holmes.
Yo, MC Bones on the microphone. I'm like a king on a throne. I'm on my own throne. Yo.
Dude, I got him drunk, dude. It's all good, man. Yeah, Who Cares?
I'm normally
T-Unit.
I'm normally better than that.
You are really normally a lot better than that.
Hello there. How are you? You're on the air.
Yeah, hi. What's up, man? I just wanted to ask Steve a question, man.
Yes.
Yeah, I was wondering, where are your whippets, man? Because I got an addiction to Vicodins, man, and I'm trying to quit them. And last time you were on the show, you were awesome, dude.
Oh, so you're trying to quit drugs, and now you're showering me with accolades for my complete
whippets,
drug abuse.
Did you quit it, or did you...
Did you quit the whippets?
The whippets, like, yeah, at first I would quit it, and then I relapsed. But, like, on the relapse, I realized that, like, I'm fucking immune to this shit, dude. So I'm just like, whatever, now I'm over it.
No, I personally know you're a performer. You're somebody who was raised in a circus environment. You've done some actual...
I'm sorry to interrupt you, but when I, like, came here and I was on the appearance this guy's talking about, I was out of my mind, fucking frying my brain with nitrous oxide, just getting wasted, like...
I don't believe you were inhaling. I think you're a performer and you were not actually inhaling.
Dude, I went on this tirade about the circus, and then all of a sudden, like, PETA, you know, posted that all over the fucking internet.
Yeah.
And, like, I got an email from the PETA, you know, it was forwarded to me, and I was like, you know what, like, when I was in the circus, I fucking, like, honestly... saw the fucking metal hook, dude. It wasn't hidden from the tassels to try to make it look cute, and they're just like, go, you know, like, I showed up my first day, they're like, stay the fuck away from the elephants. I was like, whoa, dude, like, there's something sketchy going on. The fucking, like, I witnessed fucking cruelty to animals. There's fucking animals going berserk, just killing people, like, it's fucking obvious why they don't belong in the circus. You know, like, take animals the fuck out of the fucking circus and fucking, like, dude, fur? All right. If you don't fucking eat that animal, then don't wear its fur, dude. You know? You got fucking animals being skinned while they're still alive.
No.
That's how they do it. Like, they're still,
My personal...
And then they don't even eat the fucking thing. Look at their fucking, what the American Indians, the Native Americans did, that was like, if they were going to kill it, they used every part of it. Like,
well,
if they,
in all seriousness,
they took
all,
from the land, they gave back. You
in
know?
All like, seriousness, I think the worst example of that is shark finning.
You know, dude, I fucking cut, ivory is fucking horrible. You know, in the worst,
they cut
is goddamn
the
rhinoceros.
They cut the fins
horn.
Off the shark and they throw the whole shark back in the water just to keep
the
shin.
Dude, like,
for shark fin soup, which is legal in America.
Dude, I'm not backing all
don't
the fucking...
Don't drink shark fin soup.
I can't back PETA, like, you know, like as, you know, and everything they do. Because, I mean, fuck, dude. Like, I don't know what's worse, like Greenpeace.
You know what I'm talking about.
You know? But what I am not gonna stop saying is that fucking animals should not fucking be in the circus. It's torture.
Pretty good,
it's
huh?
Fucking wrong. And people should not fucking wear the fur of an animal that they don't fucking eat. You know? And so whatever. And it was coming here and doing all those drugs that.
So you can't wear like a mink fur coat. What about a mink coat?
Right. You don't eat mink, dude.
You don't eat mink. You're not having a mink. No one eats.
It's just.
But you should be able to wear a mink coat.
And I don't want
to. Just
because
you didn't have like a.
But now that thanks to you and the tirade,
there's not a lot of meat.
I am a PETA spokesperson.
Not a lot of meat on a mink. Not a lot of meat on a mink.
Dude, I got Lindsay Lohan to stop wearing fur. You know.
Another pretty tight.
And I really, dude, like the big ups.
Can we call her right now?
We good, yeah.
Yeah? Let's call her.
And it's not going to have, like, hi, this is Lindsay, and it's not going to, it's going to be, we operate in text.
You know? You operate in text, huh?
You know, we can leave her a voicemail.
Yeah, leave her a voicemail.
All right.
Call Lindsay Lohan.
Oh, no,
you seemed like you were kind of a little bit hesitant. You almost, like,
well,
didn't want to...
Well, the thing is, dude, like...
You didn't want to break out the big guns.
Well, it's just weird, like you'll notice I called all dudes, you know?
Like, well, why do we want to talk to dudes anyways? I mean, why is it that we're calling people all night? We've got an openly bisexual man coming over here.
Why are we
not calling the hot babes?
Dude, tonight's show got fucking good.
Where are the hot babes in the phone? Let's call Nicole Richie, damn it.
That's a number I ain't got.
You don't have it anymore?
Check him on Lindsay Lohan, the fire crotch, man. She hot.
Okay.
Oh, my God, dude.
Okay, wait.
Lindsay's sauce, man. Okay, here we go.
You're calling her right now.
Thank God. Here,
We're calling Lindsay Lohan right now, friend of Steve-O's.
We're gonna leave her a voicemail and telling her that fucking thank you so much for making the world a better place.
Yeah.
By fucking not wearing any more goddamn fucking fur.
Is that her on the answering machine?
Probably.
I like her a lot, actually. I really like her a lot.
I know.
I find her quite attractive. Hello, you're on the air.
Yeah, well, Live on Tom Green is my main man.
Yes!
But never appearing here is the man called Beefo. All the bitches got hoes, but the pool's closed.
Aw, man, raps like that make me want to murder. I'll fucking have maggots eat him like a burger. Yeah, dude.
Burger.
Burger. Yeah, I'll fucking shoot him dead, and then I'll get pretty drunk, loading his body into the trunk. Yeah, his family will cry. I will laugh, because I fucking... have my fucking staff taking care of his ass, which is whack. He smokes way too much fucking crack.
Crack!
Yeah!
That was completely freestyle.
That was awesome, man.
See, that's what I do. I love this. And the show's getting better. Cheers. Fucking hate Tom Green, dude.
Hey,
you're a good guy.
Steve-O.
Yeah.
Steve-O, do you still hang out with Pontius at all?
Where is Pontius? Is he in L.A.?
You guys should...
Yeah. I talked to him today.
Does he live in L.A.?
He's got a fucking
is he here
house
now?
In Hawaii, house in fucking
my God,
the
you
hills.
Guys. You guys, huh?
Yeah.
Look at you guys.
But dude, that was awesome, no joke though. Either, bro.
Let's get Pontius over here.
He's married, dude, and much better now. You know, plus he's got a lot of dogs.
Yeah?
That was an awesome show, though, Steve.
So he has a place in Hawaii?
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
awesome. Have you been, you go hang out there?
Yeah, in Maui, you know.
Oh, yeah? Is it in Maui? Well, you don't
no,
have to say where
it's called.
But he has a place in Hawaii. That's awesome. So you go chill there and just hang out?
I'm always just fucking trying to make money, you know? Like, I was raised very fucking religiously, dude. You know? In the church of capitalism.
Really, really?
I'm just kidding, dude. I don't give a fuck about money. all right, dude. Mr. P, dude.
Thank you, okay, thank you for your call. Do you have any last comments?
You guys are awesome tonight. I'm enjoying it.
It's getting better, man. We started real shaky.
Keep freestyling, Steve. It's awesome.
And dude, I'm getting better at it, right? Like,
you're fucking rad. You're doing really good.
My rhymes are tight, and I fucking know it's right to rap out fucking up all night, right?
Yeah.
I'm gonna make the money because I am funny, and I'm gonna fucking leave my dick up with honey.
Honey. Honey.
Right now, I'm
Wait, who are you looking up right now?
I'm calling Pontius.
Yeah. Man, yeah, that Lindsay Lohan, I find her attractive.
She, dude, like, she's a really fucking, like, awesome, smart fucking chick, dude.
Yeah, I'd like to get to meet her one day.
And, she's like, the most famous girl on the planet. Like,
yeah.
It's out of control how fucking famous she is. And, like, her, like, she actually fucking not only, like, you know, put away her fur... Through Aaron Burr, but she's fucking...
I think I may be in love with her.
She let the paparazzi, like, follow her into a fucking store so she could buy, like blatantly fake fur and, like, then would put on a fucking...
I think I'm actually... I may actually be in love with her.
I'm telling you, man, like, the only fucking fur I want to deal with is... fiery. I mean, I don't know if it's fiery, but, like, if she's fucking really... If fire crotch means, like, she's got red pubic hair...
What
then that's
saying?
Some kind of fucking fur that I will deal with. I don't know. No, she's just rad, man. She's
I'm not
like,
even sure what you're talking about, but it sounds good to me.
Yeah, I'm saying the only...
Hello, you're on the air.
The only real fur I want to fuck with is...
Hello, you're on the air.
Pubic hair.
Oh, hey, Steve.
Yeah,
no. Guys, how do you guys keep your pimp hand strong?
Dude, by hitting the bong all day long, and then stepping into a styling thong.
Wait, where are you calling from, sir?
I'm Virginia.
Oh, now what's your name?
We don't have pimp hands.
Dude, what? Fucking even, dude. You have
wait, let's
30
talk to,
seconds to start rapping.
No, let's talk to him for a second. This guy's calling from Virginia. Your name is what?
My name's Tony.
Tony. And what do you do out there in Virginia, Tony?
If he was
I do IT work.
IT, so you're internet technology?
Alcohol, my blood gets thinner. This guy will never be a winner. Dude, let's make this a fucking freestyle show. Come on, how often do you get to see it? You know that all the biggest names in rap would not do what we're doing? They would be afraid.
Can you bring the keyboard out here and plug it into the...
They would be afraid not get laid.
Nah, it takes too
because
much.
I'm the
no,
one
I don't do that.
Off.
Don't do that. It's too much. We're having fun. Let's keep it casual. Put a camera back there. Don't do that, okay?
Stop can I freestyle?
It. Yeah, freestyle, bro. Dude, that's what we're doing tonight.
Sir, beat up. Tell me if you can hear my beat. What do you do out there?
It's hardly a treat to fucking listen to that beep.
Hello. Wait, is Andy Dick coming over, or is he keeping us in suspense or something? Let's call Andy Dick back. See if, is he really on his way over here?
Yeah, I'm about, dude. If he doesn't show up, we're giving the entire fucking internet his phone number.
Does he not realize we're on the
damn air? We are giving his cell phone number to the entire internet.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Can I please just say one thing to Steve-O?
Sure. Yeah, yeah. You can
say,
you know what? Wait. We're going to let you say... As much as you want.
You can say one sentence, and then the next sentence has a fucking rhyme with it.
Hey, Steve-O, I just want to say that I think you're so cute, and I want to shit all over you and cover you in my...
Ooh, you're not even rhyming, and you're gay.
You wanted to hang up so fast on that guy, you were like...
he wasn't even going to contribute to what... this is magic.
Wait, Andy, I'm holding you up to my lavalier microphone right now.
Dude, we are on...
Tell us where you are.
I'm on Mulholland. I'm almost there. Just fucking take your panties out of your...
Dude, we're about to fucking tell the entire
world. We're on the phone here with Andy Dick, whose number was... in Stephen Glover's phone.
And it's about to crawl out of it
and
on the internet.
We called Andy off of Stephen Glover, Steve-O's phone.
Andy,
talk for a second. You're on the air. Andy. Andy.
Yeah, beer.
Andy. Andy!
He's gonna be here.
Andy!
He is so queer. He fucking, dude. Fucks dudes every day of the year.
No.
It's kind of worth fear when he gets near.
Hey, you're on. Andy Dick is on his way over. It's 10:22 here. We're in Los Angeles.
We're going out on a limb.
Let's tell the people. Let's set the tone for the people right now. Just so you know, wherever you are in the world, and there are people watching.
And
over 100
fucking person is tuning out, dude, because we're actually fucking on fire, dude.
We're on fucking fire, man.
We like each other.
We're on fire, and I want to thank you for coming to the show.
Listen.
Wherever you are watching in the world right now, just to set the tone for you, to set the clock for you, it's 10:23 in the evening here, 10:23 p.m.
Here in Los Angeles, California.
I'm in my living room.
I'm here with Steve-O.
We've built this eight. You're flying some.
Chunk.
A slab
of meat socket. You know what I mean, like.
Hey, why don't you get Robert on the air and give him a little interview before?
When does your girlfriend land?
Dude, you gotta give her directions, dude. But whatever.
So she could come by here, we could meet her? How did you meet this lovely lady?
I met her in Vegas, dude. And then, like,
Come on, come on.
Dude, she tried to say that I was the second person she's ever had sex with.
So you guys love each other, then. You love each other.
Dude, and then she...
She loves you.
Then she came to California, and we made love in Nevada. Then we made love in California.
My God.
And then we made love in Florida.
Did you play music?
Now we're doing a
California
rerun.
Were you playing music? Slow songs?
Oh, yeah, there was music.
Really?
She was humming on my dick. That's why I fucking came so quick.
Wait, I don't want to be part of that kind of rap.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. So is she coming over here tonight?
Music louder.
Steve-O. Is this girlfriend of yours actually?
I've got like ultimate respect for her, and I fucking dare.
She really
her a lot.
Is flying into Los Angeles.
I paid for her, like fucking bought her tickets. I'm getting comfortable. Not one person is tuning out of me because we're really getting on him.
No. Eric, why would anyone tune out?
And then the chunk of buzz can fucking be delivered to this house just as much as you can.
Look, why would anyone tune out of this? They could be watching a television show right now,
they
which
have
is
no
good.
Idea.
Television's good. You got
getting...
commercials every few minutes.
Yeah.
You get to watch like
not the way we
like these
dude.
Commercials for like, you know, Viagra, which is cool.
And they
make the commercials funny. So that it's entertaining.
Get
a little skit, basically. It's almost like being in high school, you know, when you went to the air band competitions and everyone clapped for how good.
When the guy gets on the diving board, the wearing half and his boxers come off, and he's so psyched his boxers came off, and he gets out of the pool, the Ensite one. Male enhancement.
There's some great commercials out there, and we applaud them all.
Dude, I like my dick being small, dude. You know?
Yeah.
Fucking dude, like, here's the deal, dude. Like, women don't give a fuck how big your dick is, dude. Because when, you know, like, women...
This is diarrhea.
Women fucking masturbate. This is how women masturbate. Like, what the fuck do you need a fucking big dick?
You heard it first.
And fucking women buy these fucking ridiculous 12-inch long vibrating dildos so that they can go. You know, like, sorry, bruh. It is, and it, plus, here's the deal, dude. Like, it doesn't matter if you hit the back of the net. It's still a goal. You know, all it's gotta do is cross that line. Yeah. Oh, dude, fucking.
Oh, come on, Steve. Give me a hug. We had a hug
on the
first show.
Dude, fucking A, dude. Oh, like, awesome. Hugging Tom Green will never get old. This guy is fucking pure total gold.
Hey, you're on the air. No, seriously, it's awesome to have you here, because this is ridiculous.
It's fucking awesome.
From Australia.
Hello, hey Australia, well, how you doing?
Tom Green and I are both world famous for making awesome fucking shit, dude. Like, are you into that kind of shit?
Yeah, I got a question for Steve.
Yeah.
What was it like working with Wolf Mother?
Wolf Mother! Well, if I was fucking a living member of Led Zeppelin, or the White Stripes, or Black Sabbath, I'd have filed a lawsuit against those guys years ago. But nah, like, I'm not gonna be harsh to you. This guy's great. We had a blast in Australia, man. Honestly, like, just, I'm so, just wanna congratulate them for all their success, man. They're coming on a huge US tour, dude. I believe that's in June. And, you know, like, we're probably gonna get even more hopped up on speed in the States than we did in Australia. And I'm not promoting crystal meth. That shit is garbage, dude. Don't
crystal
fuck
meth.
With crystal meth.
Say oh, no to it.
Prescription
Say
amphetamines.
No.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
Oh, wait. Woo! Ladies and gentlemen.
Andy
Dick is here.
Dude.
Cut to the camera three. Andy Dick is here. Oh, thanks for coming, Andy. How are you, man?
Oh, my God, dude. See, like, dude, I'm like a fucking, like,
no,
so,
funny,
like
funny.
I hang in the A-list circle.
What's the best place for him?
Dude, we pulled him out of my cell phone. That fuck a rabbit out of a hat, dude.
Where's the best shot for Andy? Do we
can
want
to sit down or something?
Of course you can. Dude, can one of you
got a chair here. Come sit down. We got a good camera.
Jesus Christ.
Get a camera on there over there.
Hey, Andy, bro. It's great to see you. Did you look in great health?
I am, but I'm growing this out because I'm on ER tomorrow.
All right, dude.
We're going to work tomorrow morning.
All right. Well, we are going to squash any fucking bullshit going on in the fucking media, dude.
What's
because, dude, I've known you for years.
I don't know.
I've known you for years, Andy. I can attest to your fucking professionalism.
Thank you.
I'm completely fucking
blown
away.
I've never missed a day of work.
First of all, wait, let's stop for a second here and say for a second here. Let's just say for a second. First of all, camera three. We're on camera three.
Oh,
let's say here. We're, no, can we get a shot with all of us?
I got to tell you, I was hanging out with Ryan.
I would like to say, back that camera up.
He's
I would like, look
movie,
at that. That's a new shot. That's a new shot. Look at that. I would like to say,
Steve-O,
we should say thank
you. Give me
you,
a Frezzy. I need a Frezzy.
That was cool that you just drove over here right now.
And
you
dude, like as a genie thank from a lantern, you. We pulled you out of my cell phone.
Yeah.
You did.
You know?
Making
you
me
did.
Feel like kind of the man.
You are.
That's cool.
He no, was, anytime Tom wants me to come up, dude, I'm up here. I love it. All he has to do is call. And then if it's Steve-O and Tom, I'm fucking twice there.
Yeah,
dude, what's up with you?
Oh, twice and not there.
All right, Andy, I gotta get serious.
Why do I have to hold a fucking clunking mic like I'm in the
70s?
They
have lovely ears. I'm like the
highest. What, are you out of batteries?
I'm double up.
Get his empty one and put a new battery in. Yeah, no.
I'm double loved. I can't, dude. I can't throw it up here, Tom. Hey, yeah, it's only the internet, bro. Yeah, up here. Andy. Toss it.
I would like to say, first of all, give us a call here right now at the number on your screen. Go to TomGreen.com. There's the number on your screen there. You call TomGreen.com. Go to the number on your screen. We're here. We're hanging out with Steve-O. Steve-O called Andy Dick.
You know what makes me feel unattractive?
Driven over here. He was watching Deal or No Deal. He was having a pleasant night.
For the first time ever, I've never seen it before. I still don't get it.
It's a big deal.
But I don't get how to play.
It's a big deal.
Andy Dick, you make me feel unattractive. You want to know why?
Why?
Because you have homosexually advanced on virtually all of my fucking bros, and never once have you ever even like flirted with me. You've never even flirted with me.
Because you're fucking disgusting.
All
but,
you do
but
is,
that's why I love you, dude. You, we're
all
brave.
You do
brave
is,
shot
we're
up
cut
better.
From the same cloth.
And dude, all
oh,
you do
shit,
is use me
it.
To try and get to other people's cocks, and it makes me feel like I just aren't sexy.
Dude, you know you are, buddy.
I know.
What are you talking about?
You know what?
Are you saying there's some?
I can have some girls come up.
Is there?
Yeah,
wait,
yeah, let's
oh,
get
really?
Some fucking meat talking.
I got.
Can you get some girls to come up here?
Yeah. Hey, dude. I got a slab of stink coming over, dude.
Really?
Yeah.
Why don't you guys can invite girls up here?
Yes, I
do. Dude,
we can probably
talking on the phone.
This is who is this on the phone? Do you have a question for Andy Dick here?
Still the Aussie guy you were talking to before.
Okay,
Jesus
fine.
Christ.
Hello,
that dude,
you're on
the
air. He's been on for like 45 minutes just listening.
You're on the air right now.
Fucking great to see you, bro.
This is hype beer.
I hate assholes. He's dick. Do I got to suck and get another screwdriver?
Hi, I'm Andy Dick, but hype. Hype.
What is that?
It's a new beer from Korea.
Did you bring that here? Where did that come from?
They give it to me. That's why I'm doing a commercial.
Really? Do it again. Do it again.
Hi! Andy Dick's no Hi. Joke. Wait, Andy Jenner.
He's our first
home.
Sponsor.
My camera. Give me my camera. Come on. Do I have to? I'm Andy Dick. Hey, I'm Andy Dick.
But hi! And Andy Dick writes texts. He don't care what sex you are because you'll fucking choke your neck while he wrecks your fucking genitals.
I really don't care what.
Dude, you're the most fucking like awesome guy, Andy Dick, because nobody, everyone thinks you're bisexual, right? Is that the story?
Well, that's what it is.
We don't need to grill the guy about this stuff. Why don't we just talk?
Right now, I do.
What? What?
That's surprising.
No, well, say it again.
No.
Do you prefer guys?
No,
right
I
now.
Prefer
hey, dude,
you.
I got him to fucking
really?
Say that he'd make out with me.
No, please don't.
Children, though, right? I don't want to. Your son. Wait, Andy. Your son's been by the show. Luke.
Like, please don't.
Andy, your son Lucas has been by the show.
And you know what? He's going to be so disappointed that
How
he
many
didn't come
children
out.
Do you have?
Three.
Three kids.
Yeah, I'd have a lot more if they didn't abort them.
Hey, whose dick do I got to suck to get another screwdriver?
Yeah. whose butt do I have to screw to get another dick driver?
All right, hey, dude, now that we're really in a good rhythm, we've got good fucking, we got it back, we're on fire.
Are we on
please not
fire
fuck
or...
up that rap song? Remember the amazing rap song, Steve-O.com?
This is how I'm going on ER. Second, right? This is how I'm going to look. Let me get my close-up. I want to see what I look like. Wait, I can't because when I take my glasses off, I can't see.
Hello, everybody.
Do I look creepy without them? Because that's how I'm going to be on ER tomorrow. But I can't
Are you
see
on
them.
ER tomorrow?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Really, what's going on there?
Drama.
Dude, I'm drunk.
Really? You're gonna be doing? Are you a patient? Or are you
no,
a?
I'm a creepy,
a homeless.
Yeah,
no.
Department.
A doctor.
No, I'm a patient.
A rogue patient.
So it comes in looking.
Dude,
for
never
drugs.
Bothered.
Real
typecasting.
A drug addict.
I'm a guy. I'm a drug addict looking for drugs on ER.
That's cool. Tomorrow night.
Hey, the thing is, dude. So let's say you quit all the drugs, then.
Tomorrow night, though. That's tomorrow. Legitimately, though.
I give up a couple drugs here and there. Next thing you know, I'm addicted to watching the fucking counter clicker fucking on my fucking website. I sit there like click. How many visitors in the last fucking 2 minutes? Like, click, you know, like, you get addicted to shit like that, dude.
I know.
Like I'm an addict.
It's true,
dude. I'm like, what the fuck,
man?
Everybody in the world is
that's all you do. You quit one
that's
thing,
why
you replace it with another.
That's why I, Andy Dick, prefer to relax my brain with a little.
Hi! Relax the brain and feel no pain. Andy Dick is winning the fucking game. Yeah, dude. Dude, here we are, dude, like talking about like who's gonna be
thank you.
Like more
can
embarrassing
you hear me?
Like the soonest.
Can you hear me?
Andy Dick has been on fire in his career. He's
yeah.
like, yeah, Jaeger, dude, fuck yeah.
He's on ER tomorrow.
I'm that.
Andy
I like
Dick's
Jaeger.
Resume.
No, don't drink out of the bottle. Jaeger. Don't
hey,
drink
you're
out
on
the
bottle. The air right
Why,
now.
Why, dude? You don't want us to get your
it's
shit.
It's 10:35. We're here in Los Angeles, California. You're watching the National
dude,
Web Vision.
Great,
my name is Tom Green.
Mom is pretty.
We're here with Steve-O and Andy
that?
Dick. Andy was gracious enough to have just driven over here. He was sitting at home
called
minding
me.
His own business.
Called me on a whim and I said, fuck it.
Or no deal. And then we called him up. We've called up Christian Slater, Val Kilmer, Tommy Lee, and Andy Dick tonight. And Andy Dick was the only one that came over here.
I'm the only one.
And there's even more people, dude.
I'm
Ron
fucking
Jeremy.
We called Ron Jeremy.
He didn't even come up?
Well, we talked to him, though. He was the only one we talked to. In all fairness, we didn't talk to Val.
Oh, it's a Jägermeister fucking shot glass.
Val's been up to the show before.
Jägermeister!
He's got his answering machine. He would have driven up here if he'd been.
Wait, let me try that.
Jägermeister! Oh, Jägermeister.
They're a better client, I think. Watch this. Here's the commercial. Here's the commercial.
Do a commercial for the channel.
It's for Jägermeister. Hang on. Here's a commercial. Here's a commercial for Jägermeister.
We're freestyling.
You guys rap while I pour this. Go rap
about Jägermeister. Dick is drinking some shit. Check it out.
It's legit.
Jägermeister.
Getting wasted.
That's the commercial. We're done. Cut. That is it, dude. Send that to Jägermeister.
No, we don't go to commercials.
By the way, send that to Jägermeister.
Let's go to my rap song to show Andy Dick how serious I really am.
Oh, great.
Dude, you're not going to believe it. I was on Howard Stern.
I don't like rap. Oh, hang on.
One of my boyfriends is calling.
It's called Down With STD.
Don't freak out our audience with this crazy lifestyle.
Homosexual.
This crazy lifestyle you lead.
Buddy.
We just got a bunch of like young kids
watching.
No,
that's Tom Green.
They just
want
to do goofy stuff. They don't need to be part of this lifestyle.
Are you coming out?
Hey, dude, do you have anything to plug right now?
I'm talking with Steve. I'm on the air with Steve-O and Tom Green, buddy. Are you coming up or what?
Yeah, it's a big deal. It's a big deal.
It's a big deal. The wound fucking. Yes. We'll give you. We'll take long to heal.
Yes. Yes. Of course you can. That guy's hysterical. Wait, are we going to be on the air all night? What the fuck's going on?
First of all,
I thought the show, I wanted to come in at the last three minutes.
Do you want to go? Hello, everybody watching on the National Webo Vision. First of all, thank you for watching. Thank you for coming over, buddy. Still being here.
It's up. I'm going to give the address. It's up, Mulholland Drive. I have to tell him.
Pull me up.
Go over there.
Give it to Zach.
He's going to give you the address. Here, Zach's giving you the address.
We're on 10 Apricot Lane. Hello? No, but Andy, let me just say while we're in the shot real quick, and then Andy. Awesome, man.
I love you.
Thanks for coming.
I always come up, buddy, for you.
No, but I mean,
because one time I,
this
I
is the
one
first time
something
wait,
was
wait,
going
let me,
on,
say,
and
let
I
me,
had to
let me, let me say this. Let me say.
So when you called,
No. But listen,
I'm not far away.
Andy has been up many times, but this is the first time in history of Webovision where we've called somebody off the guest's cell phone.
Yep.
And they answered, and then just came up like that. Andy Dick.
And we
did it.
We
he did it.
Jägermeister!
Yep.
No, but I mean, for me personally, I really appreciate
well,
it.
Well, awesome. You know, I love you, dude. I love you.
Hey, for me personally, I appreciate you.
I love you and all the those guys. You know, dude, Ryan. Do you like Ryan Dunn? Tell me now.
Dude,
you don't like
guy,
you?
Yeah,
there's
guy.
Some animosity.
You know what, dude?
There's something there I can tell.
Hey, dude, there's an East-West rivalry, dude. There is, dude. Bam, his whole crew is from the West. Fucking Knoxville.
He's really
the
great, though.
From the. I mean, East-West, whatever.
He's really great, though, you know that.
He is,
and
is,
he's
dude.
Like me and you. He loves to drink, buddy.
Who's that?
Dude.
Ryan Dunn from Jackass. I did a movie with Jessica, another movie with Jessica Simpson.
Oh, yeah, I heard you were just...
Because the first one worked out so well for me.
Now, sexual predator or not, you are an A-list fucking celebrity, brother, dude. And it's fucking...
That's horrible.
It's a funny line, though. It is a... I mean, it's obviously...
That all comes from the roast.
I mean, no.
No, Andy Dick is the most lovable...
It is.
And I have anal warts.
Andy Dick is the most lovable sexual predator ever to hit on all of my bros. Like, dude, Bam has...
It's not a sexual predator if they're... Over age.
Now, President Acuff was asleep. Now, that is kind of predating.
No, he wasn't. Me and him hooked up.
Are you out of your mind?
Me and him hooked up. I'm not going to get into it.
Hey, you got the furthest.
That's why I'm the one that coined the phrase molesting Preston.
I coined
the phrase molesting Preston.
He went after Lazy? Preston Lazy?
Not the fat one.
Oh, Acuff, yeah.
Yeah, I know. I coined the phrase.
I know.
Because it was about me.
Hell yeah, dude. Fuck
I know,
yeah.
But I didn't. I wasn't. When he was sleeping, that's bullshit.
Remember when we bumped into each other on Bourbon Street?
Fully coherent, huh? Yeah, I know, right?
All right?
Oh, and then I heard from Ryan that all of a sudden you guys were gone, I guess.
I know, Bam was saying that you held him hostage and shit. Like, and, like, would not stop hitting on him. And, like,
he is sexy.
Yeah.
He's sexy.
You know.
Who is sexy, Bam Margera?
He is.
See, the way to get
What do you mean? How's Bam Margera sexy? You mean when you look sexy. At Bam Margera, you
I
see,
love a Pennsylvania accent.
When you look at Bam Margera, you say, that's a piece of meat that I would like to fuck.
Yeah, he's cute, dude. He's sexy. Why do you think he has his own show?
Dude, really, there is a sex appeal there.
There is a sex appeal there.
Making history, dude.
That's a piece of meat I would like to jam.
What if
my...
I...
All right, Hayden.
What do you think? What do you think I? How do you think I feel about you?
Can we get my rap going?
How do you
dude?
Think I feel about you, sex-wise?
Jesus.
I want to ask you how you think I feel about you sexually.
I think you think of me kind of like.
You know, like.
Hey, that guy's cool. Yeah.
When I first saw
you're right on the money.
Hot.
Yeah, no attraction.
You're right on the money.
Yeah, I'm not a sexual.
You're right on the. Then why? That's why he's jealous of Bam.
No, I'm not.
You want me to want you.
I don't think I have any sort of. We don't have any sort of flirtation.
It's a mutual respect. We love
each other.
I respect
you because you're a funny guy, but I don't.
Vice versa.
But there's no, there's no sexual attraction between us.
No, that's not true.
But between you and Bam,
well, you might have some for me.
What you're saying okay. Between you and Bam,
you might have some
hey,
for
hey,
me.
Hey, let me get that.
You
hey,
might
hey,
have
hey.
Some for me, but I don't.
I do a little bit.
I'm in the middle of drinking it. Hang on.
I do a little bit.
I'm in the middle.
Dude, here's how Tom Green is.
I'm like in the middle the beard.
Of beard. Jägermeister! It gets crazier.
Wait, I like the beard, Andy.
It's for ER, buddy. I wish it was as big as yours.
Is this the ER beard?
I hate conversations that I can't.
I call it the beard.
So wait, for real, for real tomorrow night for our 175 listeners, because they don't even watch. They're typing emails, but they're listening. We go through the extra, you know, the extra amends to make the video available, but they're not watching. But. You're on ER
tomorrow.
They're
not even watching. They're just listening, and they're not even listening. They're tuning out while
they're. You're on ER tomorrow night for real. ER, George Clooney was on ER.
He's not on it anymore.
But he was on it. He was.
Hey, that guy's a little bit goofy, right?
George Clooney.
All my scenes are with Clooney.
Have you met Clooney before?
Do you know why I'm on it?
But I've been like, no way, that's George Clooney. Like he was right there.
Yeah.
But I didn't have nothing to say.
I'm not gonna lie to you. Know why I'm on it? Because Maura Tierney's on it. She's the lead, the woman, Maura. And she was on news radio with me 10 years ago or more.
And you're
remember?
Also...
And she made it happen because she's control. She's like...
Andy, is it true that like...
bitch
most...
makes so much money, you don't even want to know. She told me how much she makes per week.
What a dumbass.
It's how
in,
much?
It's in the hundreds
people
of thousands
talk money
per
and
week.
Don't have it,
a week just coming in? What'd she do with it?
She better give some to me, that bitch. No, she's helping me out. She's put me on the show. She
can we heat up one of those damn $7 chickens, speaking of money?
And I'm feeling starved for attention.
Heat starving. The goddamn $7
are we
99
eat?
Seconds.
Are we gonna eat?
You want a chicken?
I'm
you
starving.
Eat chicken?
I'll eat some chicken.
You want to eat a chicken? Yeah.
But I need to talk to you off camera. Right?
Heat the goddamn chicken up. We got it's in the back room. We got a $7 chicken
old.
Here.
I'm
we're going to
eat old. It. I'm getting old. Zoom up on that.
Wait. Hello, you're on the air.
Zoom up on that. Come on.
You look great.
It looks awesome.
Get over here. You can do it.
Hello, you're on the air. We're here with Steve-O. We're here with Andy Dick.
I call it Doc. Well, my new name is.
From Lacetown, Wisconsin. I want to have a freestyle.
Yeah, let's freestyle.
My name is Dr. Graybeard. Tom Green.
Yeah.
My name is Dr.
Hey, hold on, he's freestyling. Hold on, take from the top.
Do you want to hang up on this guy?
No, he's freestyling.
Really?
Dude.
Sounds kind of lame.
Yeah, take him from the top.
Okay. All right. Well,
I want my clothes up.
Hey, dude, come on, he's trying to rap. Okay, once again, from the top.
I wake up in the morning like the early bird, so I can down through the toilet and I make with the dirt.
No, that's lame.
Yeah.
Hello, you're on the air.
What's up?
Hey, how are you doing? We got Andy Dick here. We got Steve-O here.
Let's see where it's at now. Is that bad? Is that a bad angle?
It's the internet.
Andy.
What's
Andy,
up?
How do you feel about golden showers?
How do you feel about those?
I need to wipe my teeth. You're not peeing on me, bitch. So.
How do you feel about giving them?
I do it all the time.
I did it. Yeah. I once paid a fucking prostitute under a bridge in New York to piss on my leg, and I had my bros filming it, you know?
Wait, say that. You paid a prostitute?
To piss on my fucking leg.
What do you mean, on your leg?
While my bros were filming.
What do you mean, on your leg, though?
I'll pee on you, buddy. I'll pee on you.
Wait.
I will pee on you, dude.
Let's break this down, though.
I'll pee on you on national internet.
No, international. And what's more dangerous?
That could be good for ratings.
Or Andy Dick.
It could be bigger
than
that.
Let me get a good pee worked up.
That could be bigger than the Saddam Hussein hanging. Andy Dick pisses on Steve-O.
I've got to do it.
Yeah, dude, we got to have
I've got to do it.
Dude, it'll be like Star Wars. You will have like a fucking urine saber match.
Come on, man.
Yeah.
A urine saber match.
I'll piss all over Tom Green's house.
Pretty well what it's all about.
Yeah. Like fencing, except when we piss all over each other.
If Steve-O and Andy Dick
is it warmed up?
Than the Hussein video. For
you gotta warm it up.
I have to be honest with you. I don't think
called viral video. Even virus.
You know
put it on a plate first.
We wouldn't even allow it here.
Take it out of the plastic.
I'll piss all over your house.
I don't want to see
any of that stuff.
We want to have a classy show here.
Tom,
you guys are funny. You don't have to fence your swords or whatever you're talking about.
Tom.
I need a beam.
Hang on. Never mind.
Go
guys
ahead.
Guys are funny.
Continue
you're
your
on
show.
Your own.
Hang
you
on.
Don't need to be pulling
no, stay
out
there.
Doing this shock
Zach.
Stuff.
Hey, dude, I'm not going to piss all over your living room. I'm going to go try to.
Why don't we just end the show?
You want to end the show?
Yeah, let's end the show.
Right. Hey, I think we made a
Andy,
good show.
Andy, come here. Andy, we're going to end the show.
What? All right.
Let's end the show and talk for a minute, like in private.
Where?
No one watching anyway.
That's not 2 hours.
You don't do. You can't do that. So creep. I didn't even see
it. It was a good show.
Unbelievable, and it'll be available.
Wait! I forgot to plug. Like, I love my fucking goddamn internet community. I love this fucking Steve-O Army. Join my MySpace Steve-O Army. I'm fucking 209,000 friends and climbing. My brand new website, stevo.com, just Google Steve-O, the real official site. Fucking load. And please, let's end on my rap. I'm dying to play my fucking rap song.
It's a, we're calling this song.
What about me?
End on the rap.
I can't tell.
Andy Dick.
Shut up.
Steve-O, Andy Dick. Thank you so much for coming here tonight. Andy Dick, thanks for coming by.
I have nothing to promote. Don't worry about me.
Watch Andy on ER tomorrow. Good night, everybody. Thanks, Steve-O.
I spent a lot of time jerking off alone. Tugging solo. But now I'm on TV, so chicks love me. That's why my dick is crawling with fleas. It's oozing cheese. I'm spreading disease to mad groupies. Stupid slut bag. I stick my dick in the filthiest trash, and no amount of cash will get rid of this rash. Condoms are something I will not stash. They take all the fun out of fucking ass.
Fucking condoms.
I hate latex. I write bad checks. I'll kill mad bitches with bareback sex. I have hepatitis from A to X.
Flaring is scaring.
Who fucking knows how many hoes I've passed back and forth between my
pores. No, don't. Get that away. Get it away. Turn the cameras off. These guys don't make. Oh my god, he actually. Oh, fade to black.